but he has halfback speed. He's a guy that can turn it on and can score from any place. He has scored 3 touchdowns, and as you're going to see on this next run here, he loses his helmet and everything else, but he's going to get every yard he passed possibly can.
He likes to buck heads. Kenny King, number 30. Now, Billy Sims is a nifty runner. He's just a sophomore, number 20. Likes to go outside. Follows his blocking beautifully. Just a natural-born runner. Gives him that great breakaway speed.
You know, he's been faced with some injury problems, but he's healthy now. And, again, we talk about speed. This guy is another super speed man.
And, of course, we haven't even talked about Elvis Peacock, number 4. The guy that broke this ball game up a year ago when the Sooners came from behind to win it. Look at that little forward pitch to him. And Elvis Peacock rambles on.
Elvis Peacock has scored 8 touchdowns this year, has 27 career TDs. And on top of being a great runner, he is one of the best blockers on the Oklahoma football team.
And hard nose. See him run inside there? So indeed, it's a formidable job to stop the Sooner offense with every one of those guys going over 500 yards, and that is really something. It also keeps them all happy, I might add. Nobody is too worried about the other guy getting more yards. Defensively, I think we're going to really see a battle out there today, especially in the middle. Reggie Kinlaw, number 62, is the middle guard of Oklahoma. He'll be up against an All-American center, Tom Davis of Nebraska, and we'll try to do some isolation on that for you to see some of the play in the trenches. Reggie Kinlaw had knee surgery a year ago, hurt the other knee earlier this year, said, I don't want any more surgery. Miraculously has come back and has played the entire season.
Reggie Kinlaw runs a 4.7 40. Now, that's like a normal back might run someplace else, and boy, I'll tell you. And then you take their young linebacker, Darrell Hunt, number 85. He can chase them right down to the sideline, as you're going to see right here. They have 2 fine linebackers in Cumbie and Darrell Hunt.
And this All-America defensive back, Zach Henderson, a free safety. And we have seen him break ball games wide open. Leaves the team in interceptions and really is an outstanding player. Now, there is another weapon, of course, that Oklahoma has, as does Texas A&M and Texas and Arkansas, and that is that they have a fine kicker, Uwe von Schaumann. We saw him break open the Ohio State game, and certainly some great theatrics and heroics at the end of the game. Jay O'Melia, the artist who does such a spectacular job in his watercolor-type etchings, had this shot of von Schaumann at the Ohio Stadium, and here is the live action as ABC was there to cover it. Remember, the last 3 seconds of the ball game, Oklahoma was down 3, they're down 2 points and won it by 1 with that 3-pointer as they absolutely went crazy. And of course, von Schaumann, whom they affectionately call Uwe von Foot here on the Oklahoma team, could be the determining factor here this afternoon.
Bill, I'll tell you, both teams have good kickers. Billy Todd from Nebraska and von Schaumann for Oklahoma both have kicked 58-yard field goals. So the kicking game could loom very important in this football game.
And Boomer Sooner is being played by the Sooner Marching Band, marching down the field with the floating OU. And so we'll be back with a final word in just a moment.
When my husband came to work here, they gave him a life insurance policy. He said, if anything happens to me, at least you and the kids will be okay. And that's what I thought, until he died. And the life insurance that seemed like so much when we talked about it isn't nearly enough now that we need it.
Sometimes a man can provide for his family, yet not really provide enough. Talk to us at Money about your life insurance needs. Mutual of New York, money for the future.
By appointment to the Royal Danish Court, since the reign of Frederick IX, Tuborg Gold proclaimed the golden beer of Danish kings. Today, this light beer of noble heritage is brewed in America, and Tuborg Gold is affordable to everyone. In fact, for about what you'd pay for the king of beers, you can now have Tuborg Gold, the golden beer of Danish kings.
Well, just about every seat has been filled here at Owen Field in Norman, Oklahoma. A perfect day for football. 71,000 on hand for this 57th meeting between the Cornhuskers of Nebraska, the Sooners of Oklahoma, the conference title riding in the balance here, the bid to the Orange Bowl. The loser, of course, goes to the Liberty Bowl. And as Coach Switzer told his team yesterday, gentlemen, it's either the beach or the river.
What a way to put it, but I'll tell you, that's about the way it is, Bill. And, you know, I sit here and I talk about the fact that they're high-scoring football teams and all that, but in a game like this with so much emotion, it could end up being a defensive struggle. And one point to remember, in the last five games, Oklahoma has scored 68 points in the fourth quarter. Nebraska has not scored one point.
Now, that is significant. Well, they're whooping it up down on the field. The Sooner Schooner is here, as are both bands, and the stage is set for this battle between Oklahoma and Nebraska. From Owen Field in Norman, Oklahoma, this is Bill Fleming inviting you to join Rick Forzano and me for ABC's exclusive telecast of the Cornhuskers of Nebraska against the Sooners of Oklahoma.
Friday, Fred McMurray and Shirley Jones host a family reunion.
I'm 33 years old.
Well, go to your old room.
My three sons, David Cassidy and the Partridge family, get together for a special Thanksgiving reunion.
Watch tonight at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
From Owen Field in Norman, Oklahoma, it's the annual shootout between the Cornhuskers of Nebraska and the Sooners of Oklahoma. This ABC Sports exclusive is brought to you by all the new 1978 Chevrolets, now at your Chevrolet dealers everywhere. By Hager Slacks, sport coats and vests, a variety that mix and match, all at reasonable prices. Hager, because looking good makes you feel good. And by Dean Witter, providing ideas for investing money wisely at over 145 offices nationwide. And here come the Nebraska Cornhuskers onto the field at Owen Field, Norman, Oklahoma, on the unfriendly ground today. It was a year ago in Lincoln, Nebraska, that the Sooners came from behind to nip the Cornhuskers and win it 20-17, and here come the Sooners. Fans on here today to watch this big battle, the one they wait for every year in Big 8 country. And of course, this one has the usual significance. If Oklahoma wins it, it's an outright championship of the Big 8 and a trip to the Orange Bowl. And if Nebraska wins it, it's a co-championship with Oklahoma and also a trip to the Orange Bowl. The loser of today's game goes to the Liberty Bowl to take on North Carolina. I'm Bill Fleming along with Rick Forzano. If you were with us on the pregame show, you heard Rick Forzano say that games like this could result in a defensive struggle, much like the game a week ago between Ohio State and Michigan.
That is correct, and both teams have had to change their defenses because of graduation and injuries, but they have gotten progressively better as the season has gone along. It could be a defensive battle, no question about it, with fumbles, turnovers, interceptions, penalties playing a great part in this football game.
And I think maybe the wind might have something to do with it today. We've got a pretty good wind blowing out of the north, blowing right straight down the field from left to right. And because of that, the significance could lie right in the coin flip, which will be taking place here in a couple of minutes.
That's right, because the way the wind is, someone may win the coin toss. Whoever wins it, it might just take the win and kick the ball off and try to gain field position early in the football game.
Now, Rick Forzano mentioned earlier the thing about penalties and turnovers. I think it's astounding that Oklahoma has gone as far as it has gone this year with as many turnovers as they've had. Can you believe they've lost 29 fumbles this year? In fact, they lost, I think, 7 to Ohio State and won the game.
That, to me, and even Barry Switzer says he can't believe it, that you can fumble that many times. Matter of fact, John Keefe, the sports publicity director here at Oklahoma, is keeping tabs now on how many fumbled pitch-outs. He said he's going to call those completed passes or incompleted passes.
A new statistic to worry about, huh? Well, right now, down on the field, we have the tri-captains of Oklahoma, Elvis Peacock, Carl Balishweiler, and Zach Henderson, along with the co-captains, Greg Jorgensen, number 63, and Jeff Carpenter, number 37, of Nebraska. The referee is Dan Foley. He's introducing the tri-captains and the co-captains to the other officials for today's game, and we will have the flip of the coin.
Heads, he called. It is heads. You have won the toss. Would you keep this as a memento for today's game?
Nebraska wins it.
Your choice, kick, receive, or defend. Either goal. You wish to receive.
Nebraska wants the football.
What goal do you want to push it back? Please.
So Nebraska says we'd rather have the ball rather than the wind. So Nebraska will get the football first. Oklahoma will have the wind of their backs in this first quarter. And we will be back for the kickoff in this 57th meeting between these two old rivals in just a moment.
This is combat in the field and in your home. New Telstar Combat, the video tank game with two-fisted controls found in real tanks so you can maneuver all over the battlefield. Dodge mines, one mistake and regroup, aim, fire. The score mounts, the battle quickens, turn, fire. Telstar Combat gives you four different battle games. So hit your TV to a Telstar. Telstar Combat by Coleco.
See what's new today. It's good news, America. Chevy's new size Malibu. Hey. Good news about size, good news about room, good news about styling, too.
Chevrolet's new size Malibu is just full of good news about room and ride and comfort and EPA mileage estimates. And that's a lot of good news.
It's good news, America. Chevy's new size Malibu. Chevy's new size Malibu.
Well, we're very happy that you can join us today for the start of what promises to be a great weekend of college football here on ABC. Again tonight, don't forget, most of the nation will be watching at 9 o'clock Eastern Time that battle in the Pac-8 to determine who goes to the Rose Bowl. UCLA and USC, Frank Broyles and Chris Schenkel on hand for that one. Then, of course, tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern Time, you'll be watching the Penn State Pitt game. Lee Grosskopf, Al Michaels will be bringing you that action. And then Keith Jackson and Ara Parseghian from JFK Stadium at 4 o'clock Eastern Time tomorrow, the annual battle between Army and Navy. But right now, we're going to tee it up to determine who will win the Big 8 Championship and who will go to the Orange Bowl and then who will go to the Liberty Bowl for 1977. Uwe von Schaman, a man who has been flawless on extra points this year, 42 out of 42. 12 out of 17 in field goals. The deep men now are Curtis Craig on the far side and Kenny Brown on the near side. And here we go. We're underway. It's a high kick with the wind behind it, and it's taken by Curtis Craig. He decides not to run it out. Oklahoma down very quickly. So it'll be first and 10 for the Nebraska Cornhuskers as they go on offense. And a good look at them individually. Tom Sorley, the quarterback. Tony Donnell, a blocking back, but the fullback in the backfield. I am Hip, the great speedster. And Curtis Craig, the wingback. Then we have Timmy Smith, the split end. And the tight end, Ken Spate. First and 10 on the 20-yard line. Quarterback is Sorley. Gives to the second man through, and boy, he is collared. I am Hip is hit by Richard Murray. Woo. And the offensive line ahead of the backfield. It will be Kelvin Clark, left tackle. The guard will be Greg Jorgensen, co-captain. All-American Tom Davis is the center. Watch him today. Steve Lindquist, guard on the right side. And tackle Stan Waldemore. It's second down, 8 yards to go. The Huskers in possession of the football. We've just begun from Norman, Oklahoma on a brilliant, sunshiny day. Long count by Sorley. Pitches back. Hit again. Is cut down at the 24-yard line in a swarming tackle. Darrell Hunt, number 85. Now, the Oklahoma defense, very much in evidence. Bruce Tate, Dave Hutchins, Richie Kinlaw, Richard Murray, and Reggie Mathis. We have Cumby and Hunt. Two very tough guys behind there, and then the defensive secondary. All right, a key third down coming up. Third down and three for the Huskers. Well, a long three, three and a half is closer to it. In motion. Ball is given a hip on the pitch back. He gets it up over the 34-yard line, and he has a first down at above the 34, but there's a marker down on the field. Richard Murray tripped him up. And that brings a roar from the Oklahoma side of the field. Penalty against the Cornhuskers of Nebraska. Holding penalty. Oh, that is costly. Rick Forzano, you said earlier, penalties and turnovers could play a big part in this ballgame.
They certainly can, and after a nice run there by Hip from the double wing formation, the power sweep, which is a base play for Nebraska, and to have that penalty is a killer.
All right, here we are with a third down and 15 for the Huskers on their own 14-yard line.
24.
On a delay, the draw. Goes to Ian Hip, and he is out of bounds at about the 20-yard line. Talk about being fired up. Reggie Mathis and Darrell Hunt, numbers 58 and 85, swarming in there on Ian Hip. And listen to these fans from the far side of the field. They love their defense.
Well, it's a wild crowd, Bill, I'll tell you that.
Timmy Smith has gone in the lineup. He's the punter, averaging 41 yards a boot. Kicking against a pretty stiff wind coming out of the north. Right in his face. Freddie Nixon, the single safety back. A beautiful high spiral coming back to the 31. Nixon grabs it there. And the Huskers, because of the long hang time on that kick, are down there knocking down. 47-yard boot, 3-yard return. Okay, let's take a look at the offense of Oklahoma. Thomas Lott, their nifty quarterback. Elvis Peacock, the left halfback. Billy Sims on the right side, and the fullback is Kenny King. Up front, Steve Rhodes, the split end, and a tough customer, the tight end, Victor Hicks. All right, in case you've just joined us, Nebraska had the opening sequence, a 15-yard penalty cost them, and they had the punt. Now, Oklahoma for the first time. Oh, look at that hole as Elvis Peacock blasts through. That offensive line was never more in evidence than it was right there. What a hole opened up by Carl Baldeschweiler. Jaime Melendez, the guard. Paul Tabor, the center. Greg Roberts, the right guard. And Sam Clapham, the right tackle. 13-yard pickup as Elvis Peacock blasts through, making it a first down on the 47-yard line. Outside goes Billy Sims at midfield. He is bear hugged. Larry Velocic had a hard time bringing him down. On the defensive line of Nebraska, a closer look at them, Tony Samuel, Barney Cotton, Odious Lee, Randy Peschel, and George Andrews. Then behind them, Tom Behring and Lee Kuntz with Harvey, Pillen, Velocic, and Anderson. All right, it's second down, about 8 yards to go, just short of midfield. There is no score between Oklahoma and Nebraska. Middle of the line, stopping that play. Kenny King stopped by Randy Peschel. You know, Rick, that first play that Elvis Peacock ran through there, I think is indicative of these Oklahoma Sooners. That's what you call explosive.
Boy, it certainly is. And as you know, they used to be strictly a wishbone. Now they run from all different sets. They really give the defense a difficult time.
Thomas Lott keeps it, ducks inside, fumble. Falls wildly loose at the midfield stripe, and it is covered by Oklahoma. Ooh, an anxious moment for the Sooner. Number six, Thomas Lott, coming up with it, but it does make it a third down, a long seven right at midfield. I checked that, that's fourth down and seven. So here's the punting situation. On Chauvin, getting a hard-to-handle kickoff. It's taken right on the play at the 13 by Kenny Brown. Ooh, and down he goes. 37-yard boot, only a 5-yard return. And so the Cornhuskers will get it back on this exchange of punts. Back in just a moment.
O
Over 50 years ago, Dean Witter was built on the belief that an investment firm's most valuable asset is its good name. Through the years, the Dean Witter name has come to stand for ideas, for investing money wisely, for building portfolios designed to protect our clients' capital, and to create maximum dollar return. That's why today, Dean Witter is one of the nation's largest and most respected investment firms. And that's why people come to Dean Witter.
Excuse me, champ. Great fight. Now, we'd like to take away your Schlitz and have you endorse our beer.
No. You want to take away my gusto? Say, you tickle me. You want to take away my Schlitz, my gusto? Well, I'm going to play Picasso.
And put you on the canvas.
You're going to be down for a count so long, they're going to use a calculator. Take away my gusto.
If you don't have Schlitz, you don't have gusto. Probably you don't have beer.
Schlitz.
The ball is resting on the 18-yard line. The Cornhuskers of Nebraska have it. There is no score with 11 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the first quarter from Norman. Rocky Loken has gone in at split end for Timmy Smith. Brody Donnell is the near back. He gets the ball and he is hit. Just about the moment he gets the ball, Richard Murray slamming it to the ground. Boy, that's quick reaction, isn't it, Richard?
Oh, I'll tell you again, when we talk about speed and quickness, the Oklahoma defense, they just come off of those blocks and they get penetration right now. They make it most difficult for the offensive linemen of Nebraska.
Second down, and about 8.5 to go. The ball is on the 20-yard line. Smith is back in now, in place of Rocky Loken. Split in. Pitchman, high and hip. Well, he wiggles through not much of an opening over there at the 26-yard line before Reggie Mathis and Zach Henderson, numbers 58 and 19, bring him down. 7-yard gain.
At the 27-yard line.
Now, Nick, you can talk about leg power. I think you really see it as he drives in slow motion there.
Oh, I tell you, he is a strong one. But boy, those linebackers for Oklahoma, they get to the ball, and that Zach Henderson, he leads them in tackles for the secondary. He was there also.
He played. Third down and a yard and a half. Ball goes to hip. Oh, he is crunched. I don't know that he made it. He might have fallen forward, but he got really belted by Darrell Hunt, number 85. 19 is Zach Henderson on the bottom. I think he's in on every single play. They'll have to bring in the chain in to see if he made it.
Here's hip again, Bill.
Briefly.
Very briefly.
Okay, that's right. First down. Big roar from the Big Red.
Bill, that's a big first down for Nebraska because they've got the wind in their face right now, and if they can just make some first downs, they could have the wind at their back shortly, so it's good.
Well, there's a pretty good look at how even these two teams are coming into this ball game. Both ground-oriented. We have yet to see a pass in this game. 9:45 to go, first quarter, no score. Cody Donnell, the fullback, grinds it up to the 34-yard line. But the fact that they are ground-oriented doesn't mean they're dull.
Oh, absolutely not. It's not like, as I said, a 3 yards in a cloud of dust. They open it up, they run the ball, but they're explosive, and they run all kinds of variations of offensive plays.
All right, it's second down. Second down and a short five. Quarterback is still Tom Sorla.
169!
And now for the first pass of the ball game, Sorley way too high, and it goes to Zach Henderson. He intercepts it at the 38 and carries it back to the 44-yard line. Zach Henderson, once again, the free safety. Hit Johnny on the spot. And the pass looked to me like it just caught the wind and just took off. Way over
right,
there.
Bill. The receiver was wide open, by the way. Here it is now. Sorley's throwing the ball. He just overshoots. You can see the receiver coming there. He's wide open. But Zach Henderson, this is Zach's sixth interception of the year. You can see why he's an All-American football player.
So the first turnover of the ball game results in the Sooners getting the football at the 44. No score. There goes Peacock again at opening at the left guard spot. Jaime Melendez and Paul Tabor working on Odious Lee and Barney Cotton and Randy Peschel. They get it up to about just over midfield. There's the stats on Peacock. Wow. 5.7 is really a remarkable average. Second down, about four. Not very much there as Tom Buehring brings Lott down, but it's a first down.
Bill, that Tom Lott is such an excellent faker. Right there, it was difficult to tell if he had given the football to the fullback or not. He kept the ball, and it looks like, it's pretty close for a first down. It is a first down. Yes, sir.
Thomas Lott with 11 touchdowns to his credit. As you can see, he certainly has the stats, 600 yards in rushing. Good reaction by the defense. Barney Cotton, number 54, coming in there to knock Kenny King down. So it brings up now a second and about eight. There's no score in this contest. We've really had a couple of punt exchanges and then one interception. One turnover so far. That's how the Sooners have the football. Second down and eight, the ball on the 43-yard line. Oklahoma in the red. Nebraska in the white jersey. Kenny King starting out in motion. Handoff right through the middle. And it's Peacock getting it over the 40-yard line. And Barney Cotton, number 54, once again making the stop.
Bill, it's amazing to see the quickness of the Oklahoma offensive backs, the way they come off the mark. Elvis Peacock, he's into the line of scrimmage in a real hurry.
Third down and three. The ball is on the 38-yard line of Nebraska. Cut keeps. Oh, and he is hit hard by Larry Velocity. The loss on the play of 2 yards. What anticipation he had. So, Uwe von Schaumann will come into the lineup, and the Huskers' defense rises to the occasion. Here's a field goal attempt by von Schaumann, 57 yards, and it picks up a little bit of steam, but it's going to be way short, even with the wind to his back. So, there is still no score as von Schaumann trots off the field and the Cornhuskers will take over. First and 10 on their 20. We'll be back in just a moment.
I'm Jim McKay for the Timex Marathon Digital. We strapped it to a Swiss mountain guide to prove it's tough enough to be a Timex.
In my life, I have led hundreds of climbers to the top, but every time is like the first time for me.
Built solid to keep running. Just look at the kind of punishment Marathon can take. Timex Marathon shows the time all the time. Timex Marathon, the digital tough enough to be a Timex.
Hey, boss, the Texaco guy's at it again.
What? Now what? It's an antifreeze wiper refill special.
1 gallon of Texaco antifreeze coolant plus 2 wiper blade refills.
Only incredible. A pair of refills alone can cost up to $5.
Yeah. How can he do it?
Because I'm a good guy.
Texaco antifreeze and wiper refills at a special low price. At your participating Texaco good guys.
High school activities programs will attract 10 million participants this year. Nearly 50% of the student body of most schools will be involved in the interscholastic program. The National Federation of State High School Associations requests your support for this important part of the school curriculum.
The reason you see Rick Burns' statistics there on your screen, he has just gone in the lineup as the I-back replacing I.M. Hip. He's more of a slashing kind of runner, but perhaps a little bit more powerful on the inside. We'll see if the strategy changes here. They pitch back to him. There's the hole, and he is upended after a 4-yard gain. Quick reaction once again by the Oklahoma defense. George Cumbie,
Rick Burns, 28.
Here you see Rick Burns again. He is a guy that has scored 9 touchdowns. He is a slasher type runner, as Bill pointed out. Watch him turn the ball upfield, but he is really hit right there and stacked up.
Ooh, that Cumbie is tough. Second down, about 6. Here's the pitch to Burns, and once again, he gets over the 30-yard line and is brought down by number 62, Reggie Kinlaw.
Bill, that's a little counterplay. They fake first to the fullback and give to the tailback. Oklahoma's so fast, they felt they might overcommit. Here it is now. See that little counter step by Burns? Now he's coming back to the strong side with the football. Just that little step was enough to negate the linebacker's pursuit.
All right, it's a first down now for the Cornhuskers. No score. First quarter. 5 minutes and 45 seconds to go. Oklahoma and Nebraska. Shootout number seven. And once again, the Huskers open up a hole, and it's Bonnie Anthony who goes through it. Number 49. Darrell Hunt making the stop. And the Huskers now starting to move with that relentless ground attack.
Monty Anthony is a young man that's had shoulders injuries, but he's had 21 career TDs at Nebraska, so I'll tell you, he's not a come down when he's in there at fullback.
Pretty impressive when you take a look at how the I-backs have done. Very powerful formation. Second down, about four. Pitch back to Burns, but it closes. Look at that. He shrugged off the initial hit and at least got the ball back to the line of scrimmage, maybe another yard. Or the first guy through that opening was Reggie Kinlaw.
He can really run, that Reggie Kinlaw. Boy, he makes it tough on that center.
This is what the I-backs did a week ago. How about that? 497 yards against Kansas. 550 yards total offense on the ground. Third down and a short yard. Key play. And Burns gets the first down easily. Move the ball up to the 47-yard line. 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this first quarter. There is no score. After an exchange of punts, the Nebraska Cornhuskers threw one pass. It was intercepted by Zach Henderson. However, a field goal attempt by Uwe von Schaumann was no good. And so, the Huskers now, with a change in the backfield, with Burns and Monty Anthony in there, have moved the ball out from their 20 out to the 47-yard line. First down and 10. Jab step by Bonnie Anthony. A good change of direction gets the ball into Sooner territory.
Again, it's that same thing. That Oklahoma defense is so quick, so fast, they want him to overcommit. That time the fullback came to his left, kind of took a little jab step, came back to his right, and again, good yardage.
You know, it's a little bit like using your opponent to your advantage, like in jiu-jitsu, you know, or judo.
Yeah.
Second down, about two. Pitchback goes to Burns, goes outside, has the speed, and he has the power to get the first down. George Cumbie, once again, knocking him down. Number 58 in there, Reggie Mathis. Boy, this Burns is impressive.
Here he is again now, the number two tailback, believe it or not. Watch this young man rush up in there. Rick Burns, good blocking out in front of him there by Monty Anthony in the offensive side of the right line there, right offensive side.
It's another first down for the Cornhuskers. They're moving now in Sooner territory at the 40. There is no score. We have 3:20 to go in the first quarter. Inside handoff. Nice play to Curtis Craig. And he fumbles the ball. It's recovered by Oklahoma. I know, I think it was Terry Peters, number 16, who came up with the football. Darrell Hunt made the stop. Curtis Craig fumbled the ball and stopped the Cornhusker drive at the 34-yard line. All right, it's Thomas Lott, the quarterback. Elvis Peacock, King and Sims. Not much on that as King carries and Tony Samuel, number 98, brings him down. Well, twice now, the Huskers have been guilty of turnovers. One interception, one fumble. Both have been costly. Perhaps the fumble even more costly because it stops that momentum, Rick.
Certainly does. Boy, momentum in a football game like this is so important.
Here's Locke, a little quick pass over the line. It's Bobby Kimball, number 21, and he gets to the 41-yard line, short of a first down. So the first pass of the ball game was completed as Bobby Kimball split in. He alternates with Steve Rhodes in there.
Here it is now. It's the option pass. He fakes to the fullback, drills the ball to Kimball. Just a little turn in. Nice little gainer. They got third down now. They have to pick it up. Big down.
Third down and three. And Lott is caught, but now he wiggles loose. He gets the first down. He's at the 40. He's cut down at the 37-yard line. He turned a broken play into a brilliant field position first down.
Well, I'll tell you, here they've got a defense. They got the play stopped, and a great athlete like Thomas Lott, he makes it into a great play, a broken play into a great play.
Look at this. All right, here we go. First down, and it's Elvis Peacock getting it down to the 34-yard line. 1 minute, 39 seconds. A very fast-moving first quarter. Tom Beering making the stop along with George Andrews. Beering number 47, Andrews number 96. See, that's the thing it's tough about Oklahoma. They have that quick quarterback who can scramble. They've got the inside power. They've got the outside strength. And, of course, they can always hit that short pass. And here comes Steve Rhodes just out of the bottom of your picture, out to the right side. Second down and eight. Inside they go, and down goes the ball carrier. Oh, that was some hit.
Bill, that's an important play that Nebraska can stop the Oklahoma fullback, Kenny King. Because when you can shut him down, then you're going to force him to run the option to the outside. But first things first, you have to stop Kenny King.
Third down, about six. Ball is on the 33. There's no score. 45 seconds to go in the first quarter. Oklahoma on the attack in Nebraska territory. Another quick one. And it's Bobby Kimball, who's got the ball on the 29-yard line. Randy Anderson bringing him down. Now you'll see Kimball go out of there, and Steve Rhodes will come in. There they go. They're shuttling on the far side. Here comes Rhodes, number 24. It's close enough to measure for the first down. Go, 37 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score. And right now, the Sooners are hoping that they don't have that fourth down. No, sir. They have a first down. It's on the 26-and-a-half-yard line. Four first downs for Oklahoma, five for Nebraska. And it keeps the drive going. The Nebraska drive was stopped at the 35 on a fumble by Curtis Craig. One thing that the Sooners don't want to do at this point, of course, is to turn that ball over. They've been playing flawless ball so far. First and 10. Second man through. What a hole as Elvis Peacock spins to the 15-yard line. A great hole on that counter play opened up on the right side. 11-yard gain, first and 10 on the 15.
Here it is, Bill. They've been giving the ball to Kenny King on first down. They take it out of his belly, give it to Elvis Peacock. Big down, big play, good call.
Now 13 seconds to go in the first quarter. 10 seconds to go. The ball in the 15, first and 10. Sims in motion. They fake the handoff, right, keeps it. Tucked inside, still in his feet, goes to the 3-yard line. First and goal to go. As Odious Lee saved the touchdown. That's going to delight the fans in the north part of the end zone because the first quarter ends and they will go to the opposite end of the field. So, at the end of the first 15 minutes, it's Sooners of Oklahoma nothing, the Cornhuskers of Nebraska nothing, back in the
today. Last year, Chevrolet introduced a new kind of six-passenger car. And like hot dogs and apple pie, America is eating it up. Now in its second year, the new Chevrolet Caprice continues to give you
more headroom,
more rear seat
legroom,
more trunk room,
more manageability in city traffic,
more mileage.
The beautiful new Chevrolet Caprice. Now that's more like it.
I've got a nice business, but I'm no whiz at financial planning. Fortunately, my Connecticut General representative is. He sure comes through for me.
Coming through for you. That's what CG people do.
My company needs an insurance representative as professional as our lawyer, tax advisor, and accountant. And Connecticut General always comes through.
Coming through for you. That's what CG people do.
Call us. We'll come through for you, too.
swing it there and now.
But, Billy Joe, you are dressed for a Del Rio dogfight. You'd sure look better in Hager slacks. Or a Hager sport coat and slacks. Even a Hager vested suit. A variety of outfits you don't have to be rich to afford. Oh, Billy Joe, you look like $1 million.
Make that too.
Billy Hager, Joe.
Because looking good makes you feel good.
Well, the Sooners of Oklahoma are down there knocking on the Nebraska door. They're on the 2.5-yard line. No score, but we're just beginning the second quarter of play from Norman. This game won the Big 8 championship, the right to go to the Orange Bowl. Out wide to the right goes Sims, just at the top of your picture. Thomas Lott, the quarterback. First and goal on the 2.5. Peacock gets it. Touchdown. And Oranges are pelted all over that field in that north end zone. There's the man who did it. A slight delay here to get the orange peelings off the gridiron. Uvivan Shaman. And looking for him, I don't know if he's gone in the lineup or not. He's been flawless this year, 42 out of 42 on extra point attempts. Now he's out there, number 10. He stepped on an orange. I think that was his problem. 65 yards in 8 plays after the fumble recovery. Von Schaumann waiting patiently as the members of the team huddle. Funny little shift of theirs. 6-0 is the score. It only took them 2 seconds into the quarter to make that tally. And Thomas gets the score. 43 out of 43, and that sets an all-time Oklahoma record.
Years ago, in the rice fields of the Orient, an unusual fungus made some of the plants grow like crazy. That led scientists to the discovery of a new hormone they called gibberellin. Here in the United States, Dr. Steve Ross, tree physiologist, is experimenting with gibberellin in a Weyerhaeuser program of genetic research. When Dr. Ross injects gibberellin into superior trees, they flower years ahead of schedule. And they produce seed cones in 6 years instead of the 10 to 20 years it takes nature to do the job. Dr. Ross's experiments in the breeding orchard at Squim, Washington have one specific goal: faster tree growth in Weyerhaeuser forests. It's just one more way we're working to stay ahead of the increasing demand for plywood and the thousands of other things made from wood. Weyerhaeuser, the tree growing company.
Great NCAA college football regional action continues tonight as UCLA must beat USC for a Rose Bowl bid on ABC.
Oh, there'll be a lot of anxious viewers in that game tonight. Big one between UCLA and USC. UCLA wins it. They go to the Rose Bowl. SC wins it. Washington goes to the Rose Bowl. All right, here's Von Schaumann's kick into the wind. It's a high floater. Not very far. Comes down to the 11-yard line. Taken by Kenny Brown. Ooh, as he hit it for 17. Driven all the way back to the 10. Number 15 there was Jay Jimerson, son of one of the assistant coaches. Ian Hip has gone back in the lineup now, the eye back, and Doty Donnell, number 45, is the fullback. Hip is number 32. First and 10 for the Huskers on their own 17-yard line. They're trailing now, 7-0, second quarter. We're only 7 seconds into the quarter. Here comes Ian Hip, and he's wrestled off from behind, a 1-yard loss. George Cumbie, talk about pursuit. He came all the way around, circled back, and brought the ball carrier down. And Hip has 9.5 speed.
Watch this now. Watch number 62. Reggie Kinlaw, watch him now. He's going to chase the play down. Just beat the center, the All-American center, Tom Davis. Boy, he has work cut out for him trying to block Reggie Kinlaw.
Well, let me give credit to Reggie and not George Cumbie on that one. Second down and 11. Ooh. Crisscross. At the 45-yard line. Out of bounds goes Curtis Craig. And I believe they're going to call us back at the 45. He's still kind of to midfield. Some razzle-dazzle in the Cornhusker backfield. And a 35-yard gain. He did not step out of bounds at the 45. He got it over the midfield stripe.
Again, Bill, as we pointed out, they're trying to counter that great speed of Oklahoma. And as you point out, they're using Oklahoma's speed right now, the advantage of Nebraska's offense by running the counter-type offense.
Craig is up on the wing. Sorley handing it off to I Am Hip. He is dropped by Reggie Kinlaw. Can't say enough about Kinlaw.
He is so quick, Reggie Kinlaw, and also strong. And he's a tough guy just to block by himself. And Tom Davis is a great offensive center, but I'm sure they're going to try to give him help by those two guards, Steve Lindquist and Greg Jorgensen.
All right, it's second down and 8. The Huskers are trailing 7-0, second quarter, 13 minutes to go in the first half. Hip starts in motion. Sorley keeps it, bucks heads at the 44-yard line, and down he goes. Hunt, number 85, bringing him down. Linebacker on the right side, Darrell Hunt. I'll tell you, Sorley masks that ball pretty well. They did some good faking in there, Rick.
Oh, I'll tell you, I was really pleased with the way he faked on that one. It was difficult to tell who had the football.
All right, here we go with a 3rd-and-5 situation. The Huskers trailing, 7-0, second quarter. The Sooners drove 65 yards in 8 plays. Elvis Peacock going in for the score. Hands it off to Domino. And he goes through a big hole in the line, getting down to the 28-yard line. Sherwood Taylor, number 31, possibly saved the touchdown there. Gain of 15 on the play. Once again, that nice faking. And I don't think you can be too wrong to keep emphasizing, Rich, about the misdirection and taking advantage of that Oklahoma speed.
Right.
First and 10. 29-yard line. Huskers have it. Their earlier drive forward on a fumble. Ooh, Craig is really diagnosed that time by Richard Murray, number 76. He's starting to come around, and Murray was there to greet him. Loss on the play of about 5.
Again, they were going with a counter play. They were trying to get the wing back on a counter play coming back. They started the play to the left side, tried to come back to the right side, but Richard Murray was waiting for him that time.
All right, here's a big play, 2nd and 15. The ball is on the 33-yard line with the Huskers trailing 7-0. A lot of heavy hitting in the middle of the line. The play goes nowhere. This program is being brought to you as a special exclusive of ABC Sports. Now let's pause 5 seconds to allow our local stations to identify themselves. Yeah, wipe your brow. I'll tell you something. It's heated up out here. Third down, 15. Sooner defense, tough right now. Huskers at the 33, trailing 7-0. 11 minutes to go, first half. Here's Sorley, back to pass. His first pass was intercepted. This one is incomplete. So, that brings up a 4th down. The ball will be placed on the 33. If they try a field goal, it'll be about a 50-yarder. But they do have the wind to their backs. Billy Todd has a 58-yard field goal to his credit. Hit one last week. Now that's just about right. 50 yards and a good strong wind. Number 14, Billy Todd. 12 out of 17 the season for field goals. This one's going to be way short. So, the Sooner defense rises to the occasion where it looked like Nebraska had the momentum going. Stop, field goal miss, and so with 10:51 to go in the first half, the Sooners take over the football.
Schlitz Light. Schlitz Light beer has a third fewer calories than our other fine beer, and all the taste beer drinkers expect from Schlitz.
Is that what that guy always drinks?
That's his beer. It's the only light beer with gusto.
I'll have a Schlitz Light.
Make it two.
Beer drinkers know it took Schlitz to bring the taste to light.
Goodyear announces Tiempo. Now eliminate winter tire changeover. Tiempo is a breakthrough in steel-belted radios. The polyester cord body and two full steel belts combine flexibility and strength for a smooth, gas-saving radial ride. The special rubber compound and tread design grips and pulls through snow and ice. Yet the center rib assures a quiet ride on dry pavement. Tiempo with a protective sidewall scuff bar from $39. Keep it on season after season. Only from Goodyear.
Should have heard that big roar that went up when the defensive team of Oklahoma came off the field. As the offensive players were coming onto the field, they patted each one of the defensive guys on the back saying, hey, that was a heck of a job. First and 10. Now a gain of a couple on the play as Elvis Peacock is stopped by Weinmeister, Peschel, and Cutton in the center of the line. Oklahoma leading by the score of 7-0. I would think, Rick Corzano, that right here, if the Sooners can eat a lot of that clock up and take a long, long time to wear out that Nebraska defense, it would have a big physical and psychological effect.
Oh, they certainly would, and they do have a weight advantage over the Nebraska defensive line, by the way, and it could wear them down even more.
You mean weight-wise?
Yes, sir.
Ooh. Tom Beering making the stop on Thomas Lott. I think he's just short of the first down. Watch Lee Coombs, number 38, linebacker.
You can see his quickness, his ability to keep his shoulders parallel and get to the football. He makes tackles from sideline to sideline.
And Tom Beering, number 47, was the one that made the initial hit. Well, it's third down and about a foot. Make it first and 10 for Oklahoma. Don't forget tonight, USC, UCLA, the battle for who goes to the Rose Bowl to face Michigan. Also, parts of the country will see the Arizona State game. And, of course, the Fiesta Bowl opponent is riding in that one. Southwest Louisiana, McNeese is also a regional game tonight. Then tomorrow, of course, we have some great ball games lined up for you. Penn State and Pitt at 12:30 Eastern Time, Army-Navy at 4 o'clock. And then you will see live coverage throughout the afternoon. Texas. Breaking loose now as Billy Sims gets to the outside and gets to midfield. Billy Sims with that great bursting speed.
There was that inside belly again, faking to the fullback, drawing the people, the linebackers from the inside. Here it is now, watching fake to Kenny King, then take the ball out and give it to Billy Sims. Billy's long stride and speed breaks it to the outside.
Hey, Coach, did you like that fake he made in there?
Oh,
that defensive halfback?
Boy.
17 yards on the play. First down on the 49. Oklahoma is leading the game 7-0. We're in the second period, 9 minutes to go. Lott keeps, ducks inside, gets to the 46-yard line, down on the 45. Keeps this drive moving now. 8 minutes, 52 seconds to go in the first half. Lee Coons making the stop. After the teams exchanged punts early, then the first mistake of the ball game was an interception thrown by Sorley into the arms of Henderson. The Sooners couldn't capitalize on that. Kick. Oklahoma then went on defense. Nebraska came down and fumbled after a nice drive at 35. But then Oklahoma took the ball, rambled 65 yards for the score. Peacock stopped. Make a third down about two now as Lee Kuntz once again makes the play defensively.
Bill, that's the third time they've run that play with the fullback in motion, and that's the first time that Nebraska's been able to stop it. So they've come up for a defense for that fullback going out in motion.
Steve Rhodes in the lineup now as the score number 24, just at the top of your picture. There's the classic push ball in the backfield. Third down and two. Lott keeps, stumbles ahead, gets his first down. Oh, he's remarkable. He was hit well by the initial man. But still, Lee Kuntz couldn't bring him down. Great balance. Ball at the 36 and a half yard line. Oklahoma is moving now. after the field goal attempt of 50 yards was not good, Oklahoma has taken the ball on their own 20, and they moved it down to the 36-and-a-half-yard line of the Huskers of Nebraska. Oh, down he goes. Tom Lott stopped by George Andrews. Big George in there just grabbed him and twisted him like a corkscrew right into the ground.
I believe on that last play there was a missed handoff. He was going to give the belly to Elvis Peacock. He faked to the fullback, but Elvis was so quick into the hole, or else Thomas Lott came back too far, that there was a missed handoff and cost them a few yards there, Bill.
You know, many of the people who have watched Lott, though, say that that's when he's the most dangerous. He's like a cornered animal. You know, and he's back there on the broken play, and we've seen it a couple of times here today. Second down at about 13. The Sooners have the ball. They have the lead, 7-0. Oh, and he goes for the long one to the sidelines. It is incomplete. I had to hold up on that. It looked like Rennie Anderson, number two, might have come up with a football. Intended for Steve Rhodes, number 24.
Well, here they get it off bootleg action. Rhodes starts into the field, breaks to the sideline. You can see that Rennie Anderson keeps good position on his outside. Good pass coverage. I'll tell you, Steve Rhodes did a fine job of keeping that ball from being intercepted, Bill.
I think Rennie Anderson even got a foot on that one. Third down at 13, Oklahoma now. Bob pitches that just in time. Down to the 35 goes Billy Sims. Inside the 30-yard line, short of a first down, by about 3.5 yards. So, with Larry Velasic making the stop, it makes a fourth down. And let's see if Ubin von Foot comes in the lineup. 6 minutes, 38 seconds to go in this first half. The Sooners are leading 7-0 as a result of a long drive of 65 yards after recovering a Cornhusker fumble. Time here is called by Oklahoma with 6 minutes and 38 seconds to go in the first half. A sunbaked crowd here in Norman, Oklahoma, enjoying the action so far because the home team is on top. Back at home.
This is an electronic typewriter. The Xerox 850 display typing system. Push a button and a full page of text appears on a screen. You can correct spelling, rearrange paragraphs, even change margins instantly. Then it automatically types out on paper, letter perfect. If your business deals with thousands of words each day, remember this one.
See what's new today.
Introducing the third generation Monte Carlo. The third generation of a highly original yet affordable car that, like its owners, stands apart from the ordinary, apart from the crowd. There is no other car quite like the third generation Monte Carlo. So drive it and put a little distance between yourself and the crowd.
Nothing showcases the caliber of Big 8 Conference athletics any better than a look at the records. Big 8 members have won 68 different national collegiate team titles, and their student athletes have won 344 individual national titles. All-round excellence is a continual goal in the Big 8 Conference.
Well, Ove von Schaumann won't get his chance right now. In a change of strategy, Coach Barry Switzer has sent on the offensive team. So they're going to go for it. Fourth down and three. The ball on the 30-yard line of the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Oklahoma leading 7-0. 6:38 to go. First half. Peacock in motion. Lott takes. Ducks inside the hole. He stretches for the first down. Tom Bearing, number 47, grabbed him. But I think it was enough for the first down. That's the ninth first down for Oklahoma. They have it on the 26-yard line. Incidentally, both bands will be performing here at halftime today. We'll have our Fireman's Fun flashback. I think you'll enjoy seeing some past moments of the thrillers that have been played between these two great teams. 6:24 to go now. First down as Lott takes it, pitches out, a perfect pitch. And it's Elvis Peacock who is down inside the 15-yard line as Randy Peschel, number 75 of the Cornhuskers, makes the stop.
I'll tell you one thing, the timing on those pitch outs is absolutely perfect. Watch this replay.
You can see right now why Barry Switzer calls Thomas Lott the best wishbone quarterback they've ever had at Oklahoma. Right there, the timing, as you point out, Bill, just at the last moment, he kicks the ball out to Elvis Peacock, and then, of course, Peacock shows his ability to avoid the tackler.
With a broken bone in the backfield, with that wing back up, Lott takes it to the five, grinds it to the two. He's even got power.
He is strong.
Jim Pillett bringing him down. First and goal to go. I'll tell you, that Nebraska line is playing its heart out. It just can't be everywhere at the same time. Oklahoma leading. First and goal to go. The ball is just outside the one-yard line. That's how far he has gone today on 12 rushes, 67 yards. Hand off to Peacock. He dives into the end zone. It's another touchdown for the Sooners of Oklahoma.
Well, they are awesome. I'll tell you, that Nebraska defense, you point out, has been just playing their hearts out. But, well, how can you defend a quarterback, a fullback, and two great running backs with speed? Boy, and then that Lott, Thomas Lott. Boy, what a wishbone quarterback he is. A runner, a faker, a passer, you name it.
There's Tom Osborne, the head coach of Nebraska. His Nebraska coached Huskers have, while he's been the head coach, have not been able to beat Oklahoma. And I'll tell you, from what we've seen so far today, it's going to be an uphill battle. It's 13-0 so far. And we have 5 minutes and 42 seconds to go in the first half. Luther von Schaumann, who set a record with his extra point on the first one today, is 43 out of 43. This will be his 44th attempt of the season. And he is still batting 1,000. I think he might have gotten hurt. Don't hurt that foot. All right, here's the touchdown, and if you were a diving judge, I guess you'd give him about a 9.5. His legs weren't quite together.
Instead of small, skinny donuts like this, would you rather have them big and thick and hot? Then get the new Hamilton Beach Donut Maker. Just put a little oil and batter in there, and in minutes, you'll have two fresh, piping hot man-sized donuts. Now you can make donuts as fast as you can eat them. So if you're nuts about donuts like me, the new Hamilton Beach Donut Maker is for you and you
and me.
Only from the Hamilton Beach Scoville World of Appliances.
Just when you're looking for a good slack buy, Sears appears with their best flare knits at a $5 savings. Regularly $16, now just $10.99. The stretch band roll waist and Trevera polyester double knit lets you feel comfortable. The colors and patterns let you feel fashionable. The $10.99 price lets you feel very clever. You save $5. Whenever you're looking for a great fashion buy, Sears appears. Sale ends December 3rd.
Great NCAA college football regional action continues tonight as UCLA must beat USC for a Rose Bowl bid on ABC.
At the top of your screen, watch number 94, defensive end of Nebraska. I believe he was the one that rolled into von Schaumann. Yeah, that's where he got him, right there. That's when von Schaumann went down. However, there was no flag thrown.
Well, I don't think that was really any kind of roughing the kicker right there. He just kind of leg-ripped him as he went by him.
He leg-ripped him? Well, it sounds like that thing, anyway. Here's a long kick going into the end zone and out of the field of play. So von Schaumann doesn't show any really ill effects from that leg-ripping. And it'll be first down for the Cornhuskers. 5 minutes, 42 seconds to go in the first half. And the Sooners are out in front. Now, once again, the Huskers have put in a new backfield. Rick Burns and Monty Anthony. And this is to take nothing away from I Am Hip. But it seemed to me, Rick Forzano, that Burns has been more effective.
Certainly has. I think he's got that power to go up there, and he's more that slashing type runner.
Here he goes. Oh, boy, that time he was stopped by Sherwood Taylor, number 31.
I don't care who you had carrying the ball on that tackle by Sherwood Taylor, he wasn't going to let that ball carry escape him.
Kenny Brown, number 22, is in the backfield for Curtis Craig. There's 22 right there going up to the wing. Oklahoma out in front, showing some fine power. 14-0. One long drive of 65 yards. And another one carried down end zone to Tom Sorley. Getting up to about the 35. That was an 80-yard drive, the last one. Boy, it ate up a lot of time, too, didn't it? Nearly 5.5 minutes. Third down now, and the Huskers simply have to get up on that scoreboard. They've got to get something up there before the half. 14-0. Oklahoma out in front. Nice hole opens up. Going through is Bonnie Anthony to the 35-yard line. A first down easily. 11-yard gain on the play. Zach Henderson, number 19, made the stop. Watch this hole.
Bill, they've run this the second time they've run this play. They knocked the tackle and end down and pull the guard. And boy, the fullback, Monty Athney, he just goes in and picks the hole and finds daylight.
I'll tell you, that Zach Henderson likes to stick him, too, doesn't he? Did you see that hit?
Wow.
All right, here's Sorley on a screen. Quick Burns gets to the 40. But he's missed at the 42, and he's knocked down at the 45-yard line by Bruce Tate. Good call. Almost a first down. That may be a first down. Very close. Don't forget tonight, 9 o'clock Eastern time. Most of the nation will see the showdown battle for the Pac-8 championship. Who goes to the Rose Bowl? USC, UCLA. Playing in that one. And tomorrow, in addition to our coverage of the Penn State Pitt game and Army-Navy, you'll see live coverage of the Texas A&M Texas game. First down. The Huskers are 50 yards away from the Sooner goal line. It's 14-0. Oklahoma out in front. Two long drives, one of 65, another of 80 yards. Both the result, however. One, at least the result of a fumble. Complete at the 44-yard line. Ken Spaeth, the tight end. 12 yards on the play.
Again, even as we talked about their running game being a counter that time.
Wait a minute. Excuse me, Rick. What does it say? Go red?
The guy looks like an ex-coach, Bill, or something.
Hey, those were his own teeth that he kept on. First and 10. The ball is on the 44-yard line, just off the 44. 3 minutes, 37 seconds to go. Following it down to the 38-yard line. Is Monty Anthony. Boy, when I first saw him, Rick, I thought there's going to be one of the really great backs in college football. And it just shows you what can happen with injuries. And, well, he had some classroom problems. And, you know, it's just one of those things. He had great potential, and he certainly is no slouch as a back. Second down and 4. Oh, wide open is Kenny Brown, and he's out of bounds at the 1 yard line. That was so well faked into the center of the line. It looked like Rick Burns was hit, and then Sorley popped the ball right over the line of Kenny Brown, and a 36 yard gain puts the ball out of bounds on the 2 yard line. We're going to have to see that one again.
Oh, wow. Here it is now, both the tight end Spaeth and now Kenny Brown. They cross the field right there. Kenny Brown is wide open.
How could he be that wide?
What kind of coverage was it, Rick? Gosh, I'll tell you, it was difficult for me to tell.
First and goal to go on the 2 yard line. 2 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the first half, and the Huskers have exploded here. And it's a touchdown. Rick Burns got it close and made that last stretch over the chalk stripe to put it in. And so, the Cardinals come roaring back.
Bill, we've got a ball game on our hands because, really, the only thing to stop Nebraska has been themselves with the interceptions and the fumbles, and they just took that ball and drove it right down Oklahoma's throat.
You know what the scoreboard says? 6 ears of corn. All right, Billy Todd is back to try for the extra point. He's 27 out of 32 this year. It is good. And that perks up the spirits of the Huskers. We have 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the first half, and Nebraska has struck a decisive blow here with that beautiful play that went out of bounds on the 2-yard line. That 36-yard pass from Sorley to Kenny Brown.
That whole drive, Bill, was really well conceived. They mixed up their running, their passing. They ran some on first down. They play actioned on first down. They ran some counter pass, and then, boy, for him to come with that off of play action and throw that crossing route and then a touchdown by Rick Burns, super, super offense there.
Well, don't forget, at halftime, both bands will be here, and I guarantee you they'll dazzle you with the music. Nebraska, 80 yards and 8 plays. We said all along that either of these teams is capable of either going the long, long pull or striking quickly. That's, I think, the thing that makes them in the top 10. Nebraska coming into the game, ranked 10th in the nation. Oklahoma, ranked number 2 or 3, depending upon which bowl you like to follow. Here's the boot. Overstreet is back, takes it to the end zone, sides up to run it up. So David Overstreet, who has made his first appearance in the lineup today. He's the backup to Billy Sims in the right halfback spot. Has started this year before. In fact, I believe he started the Colorado game. Well, with 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go in this first half, Barry Switzer on the sidelines can't believe that his defense was stunned by that wide-open pass. I think the thing that has to go through your mind, and Rick Corzano is an ex-coach who can say it, he's worried that it might happen again.
That's right, though. I'll tell you, I'm sure they've seen the pass before, and they'll correct it. At least they hope to.
Overstreet has stayed in the lineup for Billy Sims, number 22. Here's it. Watt back to pass, decides to run, goes to the 25, goes to the 30, sprints to the outside, and he is out of bounds at the 48-yard line. Jim Pellett, number 29, finally knocked him out of bounds. And put it right down at midfield.
Bill, if you're the Nebraska defensive coach, here you have the play defense. You've got him contained. He comes back to the inside and makes a big play out of it. Here it is. It's a bootleg action. He fakes to Kenny King. Everyone's covered downfield. He turns it up on the inside, gets a fine block downfield. Oh, boy.
Oh, he is.
What a big play guy.
2 weeks in a row now, our viewers have seen two great quarterbacks, Rod Gerald and Thomas Clark. Oh, there's the way to hit. Lenny Anderson really belted Bobby Kimball. Number 2, Lenny Anderson of Nebraska. Senior from Los Angeles. He's not big. He's a 170-pounder. But I imagine that Kimball thought he weighed about 245.
You're absolutely correct. Of course, he's not very big, but he's got 4 interceptions already this year.
So it brings up a second down and 10. 2 minutes, 34 seconds to go in the first half. Oklahoma on top of Nebraska, 14-7. And a great ball game here. The 57th in a long and tough rivalry. Inside, maybe a yard or 2. Odious Lee, Peschel, bringing the ball carrier. Kenny King down. There's Tom Osborne on the sidelines. I think he's done a great job this year. He was decimated by graduation, as you know. Lost the first game to Washington State. Whenever you lose that opener, you really got to pull the things together.
Well, that's tough thing for the coaches, but both of these coaches, Barry Switzer's won 50 games already, and Tom Osborne, 45. Look at Lott, 13 rushes, 98 yards.
Third down, 8 to go, the ball on the 48-yard line. Out, Nebraska, on the nice draw play, Peacock through the hole. 12 yards and a first down. Jim Pillar bringing him down, along with lead coach. Well, speaking of how a coach can bring a team back and get them back up again, I just want to send along our best wishes to Al Onofrio, who was released as the head coach at Missouri. I'll tell you something. That Missouri team, coached by Onofrio, has given us more thrills. I mean, you go back over the records, their great victory over Alabama, over SC, the win over Ohio State. Talk about winning the big ones. Our hats off to you, Al. Thomas Lott pulled out on the 35. Tony Samuel.
making the stop.
Tony Samuels, Bill, really made a great play that time because he really had to handle the quarterback and the pitch man, and if he'd allowed him to get that pitch off, they'd have been turning down that sideline for a lot of yards. A big play by Tony Samuel.
1:12 to go, first half. Clock running. As you can see, Oklahoma's on top, 14-7. But they had a 14-0 lead, and the Sooners came back. All right, Lott goes for the long one. It's a wobbly pass. It is incomplete. Two men covering on the play. Bobby Kimball was down there, number 21, but Jimmy Fisher, number 16, along with Rene Anderson and Larry Velasquez. So it brings up 1 minute exactly on the clock. We have a third down and eight situation. Now, whenever you have that weapon, like a Von Schaman in there, that's the thing you hope for, to get it down in there close toward the middle of the field. Minute to go, then. Sooners leading at 14-7. There's a big hole for Tony King. Well, he doesn't get it to the middle of the field, but he gets it down there close, 18-yard line. Randy Fischel, number 75. Lee Kuntz, number 38, making the stop. 17 yards on the play.
Bill, that was a great call. There it was, third and long. They would expect him to pass, maybe run a draw or screen, and they gave that ball on the veer to the fullback, and he was into the secondary in a hurry.
47 seconds to go. The clock is moving. Oklahoma leading 14-7. We're coming to the end of the first half. Here's Lott. Ducks inside. Opening closes, but he still gets it to the 11-yard line. Number 51, Kerry Winemaster, bringing him down along with number 29, Jim Pillen. Lott gets up rather slowly. He's had a little shoulder problem on and off throughout the year. Time out here called by Oklahoma.
You know, Bill, they talk about the quarterback being the glory guy, but Thomas Lott has taken some real lumps out there today. He has been hit after he has kicked the ball out. Look at him. 15 rushes, 107 yards. Oh, super.
Well, tonight, coming up on ABC at 9 o'clock Eastern time, we've got a lot of football on tap for you. The majority of the country is going to be seeing the game between USC and UCLA.
To earn a trip to the Rose Bowl. Then, a big doubleheader begins tomorrow afternoon as number 8 Penn State battles number 9 Pittsburgh in a showdown for East Coast supremacy. Then the color and pageantry of the Army-Navy game highlights regional coverage in the second game of an outstanding NCAA college football doubleheader tomorrow on ABC.
It's second down and 3. The ball is on the 13-yard line. Here's Lott. He goes for the corner. He's got a touchdown. Well, I can't say that the fans go bananas because they go orange.
Oh, there it is. Thomas Lott riding Kenny King. He's no one there. He just takes the football in. He could have walked in from there. Great blocking, great faking. What a fine drive by Oklahoma there.
Well, they did not want to settle for 3. They wanted to get 6 points, or 7, or 8. 7, I believe. Well, they've had a drive of 65 yards in 8 plays, a drive of 80 yards in 14 plays, a drive of 80 yards in 9 plays. All resulting in touchdowns. Here's Von Schaman. And he's 3-for-3 on the day as this one goes up, and it's 21-7. That's Thomas Lott. He wears that silk bandana over his head. That's kind of a trademark of his. And the Sooner Schooner comes out onto the field, as they do after every touchdown. There it is. All right, we have 29 seconds to go in this first half. Don't forget, at halftime, we'll be having the Fireman's Fund flashback, their return to that great, great game of 1971. Boy, if your memory is a little dull on it, stay with us because it was fun for us to go back and look at that footage once again. Also, that game of last year. There's an onside squib kick by the Sooners that goes out of bounds at the 37-yard line. So with that 5-yard penalty tacked on, went back to the 35. You know, this game, Rick, we talked about earlier, being a game to be decided by, let's say, turnovers or penalties or whatever you might call it. Even though the first score came as a result of that fumble, you simply have to look at that Oklahoma team and say, hey, whenever they get the ball, wherever they get it, they've got the potential to go in.
That's right. They certainly do. They can score and they can drive the football. And, you know, it's amazing. When you talk about the wishbone, people think it's kind of just a run-at-them type offense. Gosh, they kick the ball out. They change formations. It's exciting to watch.
Well, the penalty is declined, which, of course, is an option. They'd rather have the ball at the 37-yard line. Randy Garcia is now the quarterback, number 18 for the Cornhuskers. He's capable of that big long bomb. Goes down the middle, drills it in there at the 43-yard line. It's Kenny Brown, and that will stop the clock. 21 seconds to go. 20-yard gain on the play. Garcia comes to the sidelines, looks to Osborne. Here's the replay on it.
It's a fake to the tailback now, and he has a lot of time, a good set. He throws to Brown, coming across the middle. Brown, look at the effort by Brown to get all the yards he possibly can after he catches the ball.
Timeout. In timeouts, Nebraska has two, and Oklahoma has one. We have 21 seconds to go. Well, there's Garcia on the sidelines. Andy Garcia has what many people term a bazooka kind of arm. He's a senior from Los Angeles, had a great high school career, and has been alternating with Tom Sorley. Sorley, of course, is just a junior. Big Springs, Texas is his hometown, and will return next year. But Garcia is the kind of a guy in a situation like this who's ideal. You know, he's got good peripheral vision. He can throw the ball on a string for 50 yards. Percentages aren't quite up to Sorley's. 41 against 48. Three touchdowns have been long. All right, here we go. 21 seconds to go. First half. Sooners leading it 21-7. Nebraska has the ball. With a first and 10 on the 42. Sideliner, it is overthrown. Space the tight end along the sidelines, covered by number 16, Terry Peters there. So Brett ate up 5 seconds.
Garcia was smart that time, though, because Kenny Spate was well covered, and he just hit the ball out of bounds and avoided an interception.
Barry Switzer there. What a remarkable record he has had. 4 losses in his entire career here. Rick Burns and Dottie Donnell in the backfield now. Behind Garcia. Simchek has checked in as the defense end, number 45 for the Sooners. Second down. Big call. Garcia always hit hard at the 43-yard line as he tries to unload the ball. Is it going to be a fumble? Oh, what an interception. Incompletion, I mean. It was a forward pass. No fumble. Here's Reggie Kinlaw on the replay. There was very much an evidence on this.
He's the one to put the pressure on him and force the fumble, which they said it wasn't a fumble. They said his arm started forward. I don't know. Looks like it might have been a fumble, but that referee was closer to the play than I am.
So it brings up third down. 5 seconds to go in the first half. Time for this one play. Boy, Zach Edwards back there roaming around. Garcia, lots of time, and he spirals a long one down the sidelines. It is incomplete. Clock runs out. Rocky Loken back there, and there was Zach Henderson, number 19, just like I said, that free safety. So, the end of the first round, and it is the Sooners 21 and the Huskers 7. We'll be back with the Fireman's Fund Flashback and other halftime activities right after this word from one of our sponsors.
Party boomers go to Vegas, but the dice are loaded against them. Then,
do I have do, I'll kill you.
It's a duel to the death with a killer chopper for the $6 million man. Then,
Hang on
for John Wayne and a spectacular 2 hours of Hollywood at War. Oscar presents The War of the Breeze and John Wayne. Right after the Hardy Boys histories of the $6 million man.
Watch Sunday starting at 4 and 6 Central on ABC.
The Cornhusker Marching Band is on the field here at halftime. We'll be joining their halftime activities and their music and their formations. But to bring you up to date, I know that this is the kind of a day, this middle break of a Thanksgiving holiday, where people are in and out of the house doing some of their Christmas shopping. So we'll bring you up to date on the scoring as it's happened so far. There was no scoring in the first quarter, but just 2 seconds gone in the second. We're at Elvis Peacock. Climax to 65-yard drive by Oklahoma, going in for the score, and the extra point was good.
Red.
Oklahoma came back 9 minutes later as Peacock went in for his second touchdown of the afternoon, climaxing an 80-yard drive. That made it 14 to nothing. Then Nebraska got on the scoreboard with Rick Burns going in from 2 yards out. They moved 80 yards in 8 plays, and the key in that one was a 36-yard pass from Tom Sorley to Brown. Put the ball down to the 2-yard line. It was 14 to 7. And then with just 29 seconds to go in the first half, the Sooners came back another time with an 80-yard. 9 plays this time. A key in there was a 29-yard run by Thomas Locke, the quarterback. He climaxed back himself with an 11-yard sprint to the end zone. And so the halftime score, Oklahoma 21, Nebraska 7. Both teams played very hard and very good football in the first half, as they always do in this series. Today's Fireman's Fund Flashback is brought to you by Fireman's Fund Insurance. And Fireman's Fund Insurance is brought to you by an independent agent near you. It was billed the game of the century. Owen Field, Norman, Oklahoma, 1971. Nebraska number one in the nation, Oklahoma number two. In the first quarter, number 20, halfback Johnny Rogers was standing back to receive a punt. Many people feel that this was the play that led to his winning the Heisman Trophy. An unbelievable stop-start double-clutching run of 72 yards that gave Nebraska a 7-0 lead. This run wound up in the Oklahoma end zone. The game seesawed back and forth. In the final period, the Sooners were trailing 28-24, exactly 7 minutes to go. Quarterback Jack Milton trying desperately to get his team back in front. John Harrison open. Fires a 16-yard pass, and it's a touchdown. The Sooners regained the lead, 31-28. And then the Cornhuskers had a 74-yard drive that eventually carried to the two. With only 1:38 to go, Jeff Kinney plunged into the end zone for the score. He had carried 7 of the 12 plays in that long run. Nebraska, number one, won that classic 35-31. And that was the last time that the Huskers have won this big one. They came close in last year's game. Nebraska was leading 17-7 in the fourth quarter, 12:28 to go, and then look what happened. Elvis Peacock exploded for this 50-yard run. The Sooners went for two but failed. So the Huskers were still in front, 17-13. But here's where Oklahoma turned some razzle-dazzle football loose that few fans will ever forget. Quarterback Thomas Lott, Tua Shepherd,
who passes the screen. Then Steve Rhodes. He's behind the defenders. Catches the ball for 47 yards. First down on the 30-yard line with time running out. Oklahoma trailing 17-13. Five players. Third and 19 and the 34 and more trickery. Dean Blevins passes to Rhodes. Laterals to Peacock. It's the old flea flicker play. Taken out of an ancient play. What? Out of bounds on the 2-yard line, and then, with 38 seconds to go, it was Elvis Peacock who got the call. Anxious Barry Switzer on the sideline. Peacock sees the corner of the end zone, sprints for it, and he wins the race and the football game. Oklahoma tops Nebraska 20-17 for the win in a row with this great rival.
You know, for years, we tried our very best to brand in one insurance symbol. The Big Red Fireman's Fund. But right now, there's another even more important symbol we'd like to bear in. And here it is. It's the sign of the person who sells our insurance. The independent. Independent, because each one represents several companies, not just ours. Which means each one is free to pick and choose. To hunt. Until he finds the very best policy and the very best price. In other words, independent agents don't work for an insurance company. They work for you. So in your reinsurance, naturally, we hope your agent will recommend Fireman's Fund. In any event, we recommend Iris. Whenever you need protection, make sure you look for this sign, the sign of the independent agent, and you know you won't get burned. In the outreaches, Fireman's Fund Insurance Companies, subsidiaries of American Express.
Bill Fleming along with Rick Borzano back here at halftime at Owen Field in Norman, Oklahoma. The colorful marching red, the big red band of the University of Nebraska on the field right now. And directed by Dr. Robert Pope, assisted by Mark Hopp and Jim Regular. And of course, you guys, this music from Star Wars.
For well over a century, the area which is now Nebraska has been the nation's main street. Dreams helped these early Nebraskans to survive, and one of their first dreams was realized with the founding of this great state university, which today serves almost 22,000 students. The University of Nebraska-Lincoln is also a land-grant college which extends its benefits to all Nebraskans through a variety of teaching, research, and service programs. For example, all of the Great Plains have profited from wheat research at UNL, which resulted in enormous increases in yields from a number of new varieties. Now, work at the new Center for Great Plains Studies at UNL looks at all aspects of life on the plains, including urban and rural geography, its native and foreign-born peoples and arts, politics, economics, languages, religions, and customs. Understanding the past will help to make decisions today which will affect the area's future. A Center for Great Plains Studies at the University of Nebraska, Lincoln, making the good life better in Nebraska land.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Pride of Oklahoma, the marching band of the Sooners of the University of Oklahoma, under the direction of Mr. Gene Trailfield. Drum major is sophomore David French. You know, the flag bearers always hope that there's that little bit of breeze there to make it even more spectacular, and we have just about the right amount today so it doesn't tear the flag out of the girls' hands. But it is a colorful sight on a cloudless day here in Norman. One of the features, by the way, of this halftime will be the appearance of Miss Carol Channing, who, of course, made Hello, Dolly so famous. She is in Oklahoma for the performance of Hello Dolly, Oklahoma City, in fact. So she is attending the game here today. Talk about exuberance and enthusiasm. I don't think anybody in the American stage has ever made a more explosive impression than Carol Channing. I believe they're going to introduce her at this point to the 71,000 fans here. Here she is at the center of the field, right at midfield. Oh, there's nobody like her. I'll tell you, you can feel her presence, and she's 150 yards away from us. And what else but Hello Dolly? Probably heard it a million times, but she's never heard it with 220 bandsmen. And I don't think she's ever conducted it before. Some kind of a plaque being presented to Carol Channing. Oh, she's an honorary member of the Pride of Oklahoma Marching Band. That's what it is. Well, our game today is the start of a big weekend here on ABC as far as college football is concerned. Coming up tonight, the majority of the country is going to see the battle between USC and UCLA. Boy, that's a game that has had some spectacular performers and performances. Remember O.J. Simpson, that great run in 68? UCLA has had some thrills of its own in this one, too. You can bet that the Bruins and the Trojans will be primed and ready to go tonight, 9 o'clock Eastern time. Chris Schenkel, Frank Broyles on hand. Remember this play? Dennis Thurman running with an intercepted fumble a year ago. A key play in that ball game. So, watch tonight. USC and UCLA. And then tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern time, Pitt and Penn State, followed by the Army-Navy game at 4 o'clock. And during part of both Penn State-Pitt game and the Army-Navy game, you will see live coverage of the game between Texas and Texas A&M to determine which team will beat Notre Dame in the Cotton Bowl. This game today, of course, to determine which team will go to the Orange Bowl and which to the Liberty Bowl. So, a lot of bowl implications coming up this weekend. Now, let's turn our attention to the Pride of Oklahoma, the marching band that has just saluted Carol Channing. Now they're going to repeat a dance routine they did earlier. Stevie Wonder's I Wish is the music. She joined us a little bit late. The Oklahoma Sooners took a 14-0 lead over the Cornhuskers, and then Nebraska came roaring back to make it 14-7. And then just 29 seconds before the end of the first half, Oklahoma went up on top 21-7. That's the way we stand right now with a lot of football to be played. Ooh, the big percussion sections go to work now. Featured twirler in this next number is Pam Martin. Pam comes from Sunnyvale, California. The Warming in brilliant sunshine here in Norman today, although it's a little on the breezy side, a little chilly, about 53 or 4 degrees. Certainly an ideal day for the football players, if not for throwers. As you say, a flawless performance, and then the last one they drop. Well, now let's pause for just a moment in this band performance by the University of Oklahoma Marching Band for this message by the NCAA.
A lot of people feel that time is running out. Too many problems. Too big, too complex. It's a crisis, all right. Time is running out. But not for people who care about college. Not for people who are curious, searching, bold, adventurous, inquiring, inventive, sensitive, perceptive, engrossed, dynamic, vital questioning. Time running out? Not for people who care. College. It's worth it.
The preceding message was presented on behalf of the National Collegiate Athletic Association. The Cornhuskers of Nebraska have come back out onto the field, and the Sooners will be out very shortly. This Nebraska-Oklahoma game is being brought to you by all the new 1978 Chevrolets, now at your Chevrolet dealers everywhere. By Texaco, working to keep your trust for 75 years by bringing you quality gasoline and other fine automotive products. And by light beer, everything you've always wanted in a beer and less. So we're getting ready for the Oklahoma Sooners to come back out onto the field, and we'll be winding our way with the second half kickoff very shortly.
Let's see how Texaco is trying to increase production in this tired old oil field from a few hundred to 14,000 barrels a day. This model will give you an idea of roughly what happens 4,500 feet below the Earth's surface. Water under great pressure surges through the field. It loosens oil that coats the rocks, untraps small deposits, then forces it up and out. So far, it's cost about $18 million. But we've got to find more energy for you right here in America.
Come on, Alan, come on. We're getting our picture taken.
Special moments. Times of your life you'll want to remember in pictures.
Smile, Howard. Smile.
To help make those pictures look as good as they can, make sure Kodak paper is behind them. If you don't see these words, it isn't Kodak paper. Just look for this sign when you get your pictures. Kodak paper, for a good look at the times of your life.
Gee, wasn't that fun?
Are you still chained to?
Gotcha.
The rechargeable Norelco rotary razor lets you walk away, free from nicks and cuts. Its 36 surgical steel rotary razor blades are safely protected inside three floating heads to give you a comfortable shave that's razor close, razor smooth, for up to 3 weeks on a single charge. The rechargeable Norelco rotary razor. It lets you walk away from gotcha.
This is Bill Fleming, along with Rick Forzano, welcoming you back to Norman, Oklahoma, where the halftime score is Oklahoma 21, Nebraska 7. Let's take a look at how things went statistically in the first half. Rick?
Well, Bill, really, there's not much difference in the statistics. The difference to me in this football game are the two turnovers by Nebraska, the interception and the fumble, which stopped them, and the other is Thomas Lott. He is just something else, and he's the guy that 16 rushes 119 yards. So it's Thomas Lott for Oklahoma, the turnovers by Nebraska. That's the difference in this football game.
All right, and we're set to go. Nebraska won the toss to begin the game, chose to take the football. Now Oklahoma decides they want the football, and they send David Overstreet and Fred Nixon back. There are the stats on Thomas Lott. Of course, he's not in on the kickoff, a rather dangerous maneuver for someone as important as Thomas Lott. Now, we have Billy Todd back getting ready to boot, and we're just about ready to get underway as the shadows lengthen here in Norman. Good kick, solid, deep, out of the field of play. 71,184 people on hand here today. This game sold out since well into the middle of the summer. So, now Oklahoma. Well, they'd like to put the clincher in here. They're leading 21-7. They feel that they can control that ball, move it down the field, and score. They might be able to move this one out of range.
Well, on the other side, Nebraska is looking for some type of turnover or a big play where they can get back into this ball game.
All right, it's Thomas Clark, the quarterback. In the wishbone behind him is Kenny King in motion. Hand off to Peacock, and there's the first play of the ball game repeated as the first play of the second half. They'd love to send Peacock up that big hole. 9 quick yards on that one. Lee Kuntz, number 38, brought him down.
And not to repeat myself again, Bill, but Elvis Peacock is into that line of scrimmage so quickly.
You see Lee Hover there, number 9 on your screen. He's gone in the lineup. Breaking through is Kenny King. First down. On the 38-yard line. Lee Kuntz, number 38, again in on the stop. Well, two plays, 13 yards. Not a bad average. Here comes Bobby Kimball, number 21, reporting into the lineup for the Sooners. Goes out, has the split end, wide to the right. First down. Pitch back goes to Billy Sims. Outside, he swings to the 40. Goes to the 42, spun out of bounds, right in front of the Cornhusker bench. Jim Pillen, number 29, and Timmy Fisher, number 16, making the stop. We've just begun the second half of the play. Oklahoma went out to a 14-0 lead in the first half, and then Nebraska came back to make it 14-7. Oklahoma, with 29 seconds to go before the end of the first half, made it 21-7. Nebraska kicked off to Oklahoma. That's where we are right now with the second down. The ball is on the 42-yard line, second and 5. Sooners in the dark red uniforms, Nebraska in white. Here's Lott. Finds the hole. Belted at the ground at the 49-yard line. Lee Kuntz, number 38. What a set of shoulders he's got. Watch him here.
Oh, I'll tell you, this young man is all over the field. Watch him. He's got a nose for the football. There he is, putting the stop on Thomas Lott. He has been on a ton of tackles.
He's a punishing tackle.
Ball at the center, 49.
Butcher. First down. The ball just short of the 49-yard line. Lee Homer has gone in. Split to the left side this time. And it's Billy Sims. You know, you hear a lot about the center of Nebraska, Tom Davis, but I've been watching Paul Tabor, number 73 of Oklahoma. Watch him. Just keep your eye on the way he wedges out of there. He's tough, and he's got a hard man over him. Either Odious Lee or Weinmeister, either one are very, very tough. Maybe he's gotten himself up for this game, knowing that Tom Davis is on the other side, right?
Oh, good ball.
Billy Sims, just driven to the ground by Jeff Hansen, number 48.
There's Saber on a block back. Look at his leg drive. Boy, they just buried that defensive tackle for the...
Yeah, see how low he was?
Oh, Lord, he got into it.
That always amazes me about a center, Rick, because they measure here for the first down. How they can snap that ball and stay so low and still not be crawling.
I'll tell you, it takes a talented athlete to play offensive center.
First down, 18 first downs for Oklahoma. We're just into the third quarter. Steve Rhodes has gone in the lineup, number 24. There he goes up to the top of your screen. Not much there. Fumble. Wild scramble for the ball. Recovered by Nebraska. There's the break. There's the break that Rick Corzano said earlier that Nebraska had to play for. Tony Samuel and Odious Lee, number 65. I believe Odious Lee maybe got the ball and Samuel made the hit. First down on the 39-yard line. The Huskers have it, trailing 21-7. Today, Nebraska's field position today has been their own 20, their own 18, their own 20, 17, 20, and 32. Now they get it at the 39. Sorry, pitches back to I.M. Hip, goes outside, gets to the 43. Zach Henderson leads three others over there to belt him out of bounds. Mike Babb, number 14 in on the play, along with number 58, Mathis.
Bill, you'll notice that Nebraska spends a lot of time at the line of scrimmage, but they audible just about every one of their offensive plays at the line of scrimmage. They check off.
Mike Babb goes out of the lineup limping, number 14, defensive back. Darrell Ray is in place of him. A lot of traffic in the middle and not much on the game. He's short of a first down. Cody Donnell, the fullback, stopped by Reggie Kinlaw and George Cumbie. Kinlaw wears number 62 and Cumbie number 28. We have 12 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the third quarter. Don't forget, later on tonight, most of the country will be seeing the USC-UCLA game, 9 o'clock Eastern time. Also regionally telecast will be Arizona State and Arizona, southwestern Louisiana, and McNeese State. Exactly 12 minutes to go, third quarter, third down and two. The Huskers have the ball in an all-important situation for them. They're down by 14. Close to a first down. Duddy Donnell covering the ball well, gets his nose right on the 49-yard line. It certainly will be close enough for a measurement. Tate Henderson all gathered around there. There's Donnell, a good look at him. 4-yard average today. In this scheme of the I formation that that Nebraska has, they really rely on that fullback as a blocker, don't they?
Mostly, yes. The tailback's the big ball carrier. He's got to carry the ball and he's got to make yards for you. Every once in a while you send the fullback up the middle on a quick trap or a straight-ahead play.
Boy, it can't be much. It's not more than 8 inches. No question about what they're going to do. Sorely asking for quiet. Think you'll get it? He's got a first down right at midfield. Tom Sorely taking it himself behind All-America center Tom Davis. Number 52. Watch Davis blocking here. Number 52, just to the left of your picture. There he's got to take Kinlaw. Tough assignment, but he goes right up with him. Sets his jaw right against that face mask and drives him back. Up
got
the first down. Out of leverage. He's looking. First and 10. Pitch back, fumble, covered by Kinlaw. Reggie Kinlaw comes up with the football, and he's going to take it off the field with it, I think. You know, it didn't look to me like I.M. Hip even knew the ball was coming. I'd like to see that again.
here. It's tough to see. It's tough to see the fumble, but you can see that Reggie Kinlaw has beat the block, and he's going to recover the fumble.
Boy, there's a great individual effort.
Now
I think we can see. Oh, no. Took his eyes off the ball.
Certainly did.
There goes Kenny King slashing through to the 34-yard line. Well, a quick turnaround here as the Sooners coughed up the football, and then the fumble by Nebraska hands it right back to them at the 34-yard line now. Lee Hover, number 9, is in at the split end, goes out to the top of your picture. Thomas Lott, who's played all the way at quarterback, sends King in motion. There's a penalty marker down. Backfield illegally in motion. Now you can send one man in motion, either parallel to or away from the line of scrimmage. But it may very well have been that King was slanting slightly forward. Or maybe somebody else moved. But the fact is that that is the first penalty of the game against Oklahoma, which has had something over 600 yards in penalties so far this year. More than 60 a game. So it makes it second down. Barry Switzer kneeling on the sidelines. His Oklahoma teams have never lost to Nebraska. He's in his fifth year. Here's Lott keeping it after putting it inside. And he is just short of a first down as Odious Lee brings him down. That is not an adjective. I mean, that is the man's name, Odious.
You know,
it's Bill, O-U-D-I-O-U-S.
Excuse me, Bill. This Thomas Lott, it looks like he's maybe going to pick up 1 or 2 yards. And when you look it all over, the guy's got 4 or 5 yards on a carry.
Oklahoma, 302 yards rushing. Nebraska, 149. Third down and a foot. And Lott falls over the pile up there and makes the first down. We have 9 minutes, 58 seconds to go in this third quarter. In passing today, Oklahoma has completed 2 out of 5 for a total of 12 yards. And Nebraska has completed a total of 4 out of 9. Timeout is called on the field. 9:51 to go, third quarter. The Sooners lead it 21-7.
Oh, this is perfect. Could you hold this for me? I get paid Friday.
I'm sorry. This is a Christmas special.
Oh, how about a deposit? Do you take postage stamps?
You take MasterCharge, don't you?
MasterCharge? Of course.
You've just seen Clout in action. Clout is your MasterCharge card, your personal account for Christmas shopping in over 2 million places. Harry Clout. And
well, you're looking at the Nebraska band on the far side. Tubas turn skyward here as the shadows begin to fall over them. Oh, it's been an ideal day for football. Great for the renewal of this traditional rivalry. First down and 10 for the Sooners at the Nebraska 32. Oh, look at that hole. And it closes quickly as Billy Sims races through and gets to the 27-yard line, and Barney Cotton brings him down. You know, there are many, many backs in the country this year. Great running backs. Earl Campbell, Terry Miller, Theotis Brown, whom you'll see tonight, Charlie White, whom you've seen tonight. But I don't think there's a team in the country that has more good running backs in the same backfield, right?
Well, I'd second that one, Bill. I haven't seen better ones.
I mean, to get one or two, but to have as many as they have. Oh, there's a marker down as Kenny King gets almost to the point of a first down. Jeff Carpenter making the stop. Backfield illegally in motion again. Somebody is just starting a fraction too soon. So that will make it. Let's just see who moves. Now there's Sims.
Just a hair too soon.
You can't move anything. I mean, you can't move your arm or anything. What, you have to stay in that locked position. Seven rushes, 48 yards for Billy Sims. Hey, wonder why that shot moves a little bit on your screen. That cameraman up in that south end zone on his platform is bucking a pretty good headwind today. Might have to give him some Dramamine. Hey, that's a salute to the old Navy coach, Rick Corzano. Second down, 11. Peacock tries to swing outside. Good defensive play. Tony Samuel, number 98. Locked him up. Well, that Army-Navy game. Keith and Aaron will be there tomorrow at 4 o'clock Eastern time. That's always a great classic. Hope you'll watch it.
Here it is, a little counter to Elvis Peacock. And again, Tony Samuel stays at home. And then the tackle is made by number 46.
All right, it's third down on 11. And about to the 29-yard line, Lee Koontz making the stop on Kenny King. That brings up third down and about eight to go. Check that, fourth down and eight to go, and Von Schaman is standing on the sideline. Now he's on the field. There's a player hurt at the 28-yard line, and I'm trying to put the glasses on him there to see who it is. It's an Oklahoma player. And I just got the wind knocked out of him. Is it Kenny King? Looks like it is. He's all right. Played quite a ball game today. He's got 53 yards and 10 carries. Incidentally, Rick Rosano and I will be picking the Chevrolet offensive and defensive players of the game. A little bit later on, Chevrolet will be sending a $1,000 scholarship in their names to the general scholarship fund of their institution. All right, here's Von Schaman, a 45-yard field goal attempt. It's up. It looks good. He's got it. Against the wind. Uwe Von Schaman boots it through. Boy, he'll never forget that magic moment in his life against Ohio State back on the 24th day of September when, with 3 seconds to go, his team trailing by two, he gave him that victory. Now he puts his team up 24-7 over Nebraska.
Our house?
Except for the insurance and closing.
Oh, well, what insurance company?
They're all the same.
Allstate's different.
Different? How?
We give a 10% discount for newer homes.
Oh?
It's a 10% discount.
About 10% off our rate.
On basic homeowners insurance for houses 5 years old or less.
Allstate's different, all right.
Good hand.
Oh, boy.
When it takes being different to be better, Allstate will do it.
That's a promise from us. The good hands people.
There's this big argument going on about light beer from Miller.
Right.
Some guys argue the best thing about it that it's less filling.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
It has a third less calories than their regular beer. Other guys say the best thing about it is its great taste.
Hear.
I feel very strongly both ways. After all, I'm not the kind of a guy who ever gets into an argument.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
A homemaker talks about college.
Now I share the things that I learn, but most of all, education has been for myself and how to be happy within myself.
It's worth it.
One of our great affiliated stations, KTUL in Tulsa, has brought their sign here today, and we thank you, Tom Goodgame, Jimmy Lake, for all of your good wishes. Out of bounds it goes at the 9-yard line. Always fun to come to Oklahoma. Boy, it seems like ABC Sports has spent half the year here. We were in Tulsa at Southern Hills for the United States Open Golf Championship. Several weeks ago, we were in Oklahoma in Stillwater for the Oklahoma State game against Nebraska, which I'm sure you saw. And then just about 11 days ago, we were here for the game between Oklahoma and Colorado. So the 5-yard penalty will be tacked off with the ball going out of bounds on the kickoff. Well, now it's beginning to tell. There it is, Rick, 308 yards for Oklahoma on the ground.
Boy, I'll tell you, they've just controlled it.
Oklahoma leading this one 24-7 now with 8 minutes to go in the third quarter. Who's going down to Curtis Craig. He gets to the 27 and that's all. Mike Coast, number 54, making the stop. Now the question is, what will Nebraska do? I rather imagine they're going to have to go to the air with Tom Sorley in the lineup right now. Sorley, Hip, Cody Donnell, Curtis Craig in the backfield. First and 10, the ball on the 28-yard line. Nebraska trailing by 17 points. Sorley pitches it out. Hip, cut down. Well, I'll tell you something. The Oklahoma defense on Hip has given him exactly 22 yards in 10 carries. His average coming into the game was 7 yards exactly. And his average today, 2.3. Second down, about 8. Ball on the 30-yard line. Rick Burns has gone to the lineup now in place of him. Sorley gets it over the line to Spade. And it will be a first down. There's an Oklahoma player hurt on the play. That's Zach Henderson, number 19, the free safety. Boy, anxious moment there for a minute. I thought it might have been a knee.
Yes.
14 yards. Well, he's all right. He's trotting over to the far side.
Fred Hoover is replacing Zach Henderson. Go ahead, Adam.
6 interceptions. Already named to a couple of All-American teams. First down now for Nebraska. They're trailing 24-7, ball on the 44-yard line. And now the handoff goes back to the man, and a pass goes to Curtis Taylor. The quarterback handed off to Burns, who handed it back to him, and Craig is on the receiving end, and it gained only 7 yards. So despite all the trickery, it didn't get much.
Here it is. It's just a pitch to the tailback. He gives it back to the quarterback. Quarterback throws the football way over on the left side. But I'll tell you, the play that is made is George Cumbie. He has made 3 tackles that have been something else in the last 3 or 4 plays.
Right, Terry Peters might have gotten in there just a shade late, but nothing was called. Rick Burns, stop. He just got his nose over that midfield stripe and pushed back. So it's going to bring up a third down. Sorley, incidentally, has completed 5 in a row now. Cumbie may have had the wind knocked out of him a little bit on the play. Well, that entire Oklahoma defense, you know, that Tayton, Hudgens, Kinlaw, Murray, Mathis, Cumbie, Henderson, Hunt, been tough. Third down and 3. Pitch goes to Rick Burns. Goes to the 45. Has a first down at the 44-yard line. It's very important, of course, for Nebraska to keep that ball and keep it moving and get back up on that scoreboard.
Big thing in a situation like this, Bill, and Nebraska's shown it, is not to get greedy, to have patience, because there's still 5 minutes and 24 seconds or 23 seconds left in the third quarter. If they're patient, they can get back in this ball game.
First down. All on the 43-and-a-half-yard line of the Sooners. I.M. Hip is back in the lineup. Inside handoff goes to Curtis Craig. Yeah, it's Kenny Brown who's in there in place of Craig, number 22 instead of 33. No, it is Craig. But for a minute, I saw a 2 on that jersey.
40-yard line, second down 7.
Ball is right on the 40-yard line. The point to be gained is the 33. 4 minutes, 44 seconds to go, third quarter. Sooners of Oklahoma on top, 24-7. Handoff goes to I.M. Hip. Boy, he's frustrated today. He just cannot shake that one leg loose as George Cumbie and Reggie Kinlaw, numbers 28 and 62, bring him down.
Well, it's going to be tough picking that Chevrolet defensive player of the game because George Cumbie and Reggie Kinlaw have just played themselves super defense.
Nebraska with 14 first downs. Oklahoma has 19. Oklahoma has 24 points. Nebraska has 7. It's a 3rd and 6, the ball on the 39-yard line. Sorley. Beleaguered and dropped at the 45-yard line by Darrell Hunt, number 85. And it brings up a fourth down for Nebraska. And once again, the Oklahoma defense has hung in there tough. Ted Smith has gone in the lineup as the split end, number 84. He's the punter. Nixon is back, number 11. See the way that ball was snapped back there? It's like a bull. So it goes out of the field of play, and when time is resumed, it'll be Oklahoma in possession of the football at the 20-yard line, and they're leading in the game 24-7. What's
new today? There's a big difference between these two Chevette two-door hatchbacks. The difference is the 78 has a manufacturer's suggested retail price that's considerably lower than what the 77 model would have cost, equipped the same way. We've taken $411 worth of extras and made them standard for 1978, even a Delco AM radio. The new Chevy Chevette. It's a lot more car for a lot less money. How long's it been since anybody offered you more for less?
I'm Carlton Fisk, and I don't smoke, but I still enjoy tobacco. I've joined the millions of guys who use smokeless tobacco, like Copenhagen. Just a little gives me great tobacco flavor. Whether I'm swinging an axe in New Hampshire or a bat in Boston. So try Copenhagen, Skoal, or Happy Days Mint. Tobaccos you enjoy without smoking. Hope it clears the fence.
Great NCAA college football regional action continues tonight as UCLA must beat USC for a Rose Bowl bid on ABC.
Only four backs have carried the ball today for Oklahoma, but those four backs have been devastating. Nebraska ate up almost 5 minutes on the clock, but they couldn't score. That really does hurt, especially when you're down by 17. First and 10 for Oklahoma. Once again, Elvis Peacock. 10 quick yards. It seems like every first down, that left side of the line opens up with Jaime Melendez and Carl Baldesweiler leading the way, and Peacock blasts through. Gee, that was a big hole.
I don't know how many times they've run that play today, that little counter with fullback motion, but I've only remember it being stopped one time.
Now they got 9 yards and 2 feet. Second down and a foot. There it is again.
Down to Peacock. First down to the 1 yard line.
Lee Kuntz and Larry Velasic bringing out Elvis Peacock. That's got to put him up close to 100 yards. 99, as a matter of fact.
There it again. Now just that little fake to Kenny King. Draws a linebacker to that side. Peacock hits a hole in a hurry. The left side, Melendez, Baldesweiler. Boy, I'll tell you, they opened up a big hole.
That's the 20th first down for the Sooners today. They have the ball and they have the lead. We're in the third quarter with time running out. 2:25 to go. Up to the 49-yard line as David Overstreet, number 22, carries, and Lee Kuntz knocks him down. Don't forget tonight here on ABC, most of you will be seeing the USC-UCLA game. Some parts of the country will see Arizona State in Arizona and McNeese in southwest Louisiana. And tomorrow, more action coming up. Penn State and Pitt at 12:30 Eastern Time, Army-Navy at 4 o'clock. And in both of those games, live coverage of the Texas A&M-Texas game. Thomas Rock fumbled the ball and picked it up and still got a yard and a first down. How about that one?
Yeah. First down, that's a
down. Keep in mind, too, that Thomas Lott is only a junior. George Cumbie is a sophomore. How'd you like to have those fellas coming back?
That would be nice.
They lose Elvis Peacock, of course, in the backfield. But Billy Sims is just a sophomore. Kenny King is a junior. Ooh, there's a good hit. Number 51 of Nebraska, Kerry Weinmaster, is very much in evidence today, and he really was there. Second down, about eight. The ball is on the 46-yard line. The Sooners of Oklahoma now very content to take as much time as they want to. There's Weinmaster, hurt earlier in the year. Gave Odious Lee a chance to move in at middle guard. Now Weinmaster is back. Second down, about eight. And it's short of a first down. Jim Pillen knocking Kenny King down. Pillen, number 29, getting up there. Oh, he's played a heck of a game, too. So it makes it third down and about 2.5 to 3 yards to go. We have 31 seconds to go in the third quarter. The Sooners leading 24-7. Nebraska has not won this game since 1971. Joe Curtis comes into the lineup as the offensive left guard for Jaime Melendez. Third down, 2.5 to go. Great hit, and Lott shrugs it off and gets back to the 40. Who was the first man through? Jeff Hansen, number 48. Oh, he threw a shoulder into Lott, and I think it hurt him. Hurt Lott. Gets up very slowly. There he is, Jeff Hansen. Oh, he just roared through there. Great, great play on third down, making it fourth and two. NCAA college football. Nebraska-Oklahoma game will continue after station identification.
Someone a home in the valley. Someone a house on a hill. Savings and loans lend the money to buy. They build your money as well.
Savings and Loan Associations finance more homes than all other financial institutions combined.
Put your money where it builds America. Get your savings.
When I'm assigned to shoot a guy like John Newcomb, I pack my Canon AE-1 with several lenses. Because I'm after more than just John's form. Creativity means capturing his intensity.
Try, John.
Me?
Sure.
The AE-1 is so simple, you can really concentrate on your subject. About all you do is focus and click.
The surprisingly affordable Canon AE-1. So advanced, it's simple.
Sunday, John Wayne in a spectacular two-hour look as Hollywood goes to war.
Those are the cumulative statistics for the game through three quarters of play, but significantly in the third quarter, Oklahoma had 107 yards rushing and Nebraska had seven. All right, Ove Van Schaman has come into the lineup. He has put the tee down at the 46.5-yard line. And on fourth down and two, it looks as if the Sooners are going to try for what will amount to a 56.5-yard field goal. There's the angle from the end zone. They're leading it 24-7. We're underway with the fourth quarter, and the kick is on its way. It is long enough. It is wide. It is wide to the right. To the left, I mean. Wide to the kicker's left. The viewers behind the goal line to their right. So Von Schaumann leaves the field of play, and Nebraska will take over the football. Thomas Lott there on the sideline. Hey, bud. Hi, Grandma. Grandmas. Oh, that's nice. You got two of them. Well, this has been a great Thanksgiving holiday for these fans. 71,148 turning out for this one. Tom Sorley, the quarterback, pitching it back. On the reverse, he hands the ball off. Coming wide is Curtis Craig, and he is pulled down from behind at the 38-yard line by Mike Babb, number 14. Sorley to hip to Craig.
Well, for a while there, Bill, it looked like he had a real wall. Here it is now. In motion goes Curtis Craig. They flip the ball out to the tailback, and he hands back again.
Now, that's interesting because, you know, they sent Craig in motion, and then he came back, button-hooked around to get it. Lonnie Anthony, I am hip, in the backfield. First down, 18-yard gain on that play. Here's Sorley. He's got a man free, hits him with it, but not for much. At the 41-yard line, Curtis Craig, falling down backwards, is gets it up, I'd say maybe 3 yards on the play at most. Second down and about seven. The Sooners of Oklahoma leading this ball game 24-7. In case you joined us a little bit late, after a scoreless first period, Oklahoma went on top with 2 seconds gone in the second quarter, made it 14-0 in the second quarter. Then Nebraska came back to make it 14-7. Then it was 21-7 and now 24-7. I am hip. Lost on the play, back to the 37-yard line. Reggie Kinlaw, number 62. A menace to the Nebraska backfield. I am hip has been held at 21-yard trick. How many carries?
12 carries. Boy, he's got to think that he's been wearing Reggie Kinlaw all day long.
Third down and 11. Here goes Kenny Brown in motion. Sorley back to pass. The rush is on. He hits his man. Over the center of the line is Ken Spaeth, the tight end. Zach Henderson right there. Boy, did you see Kinlaw in on that one again?
Oh, Lord.
At the 41-yard line.
Here it is again now. It's just another misdirection. They start off to the right side. Ken Spaeth sits in there, delays a little bit, finds a little opening. Has good ball concentration, bobbles it just a little. But boy, he's going to pay a price here for catching the football.
And it breaks up a fourth down, 1 yard to go. Craig has brought the play in from the sidelines. Sorley is 7 in a row on his passes. He needs this one, fourth and one. It may have been too much time. There's a marker down. That's it, delay a game against Nebraska. He did not beat the 25-second count. So Tim Smith, the punter, will go in for the Huskers. Well, do they have a fake punt play?
I don't know, but I'll tell you, boy, that was a critical penalty to get a delay a game there.
Timmy Smith is back. He has a 41-yard punting average. But with 12:26 to go, and the Huskers really need to get the ball.
Come on, Ben.
Short kick. And it's touched by an Oklahoma player. The marker goes down. Lee Hover. Back, I don't know, I didn't see it. Did he call for a fair catch? He did. It was in the shadows there, and I couldn't see it.
Nebraska interfered with his ability to make the catch. They ran right into him, so that'll be a 28-yard punt. It was a good play by, I believe it was Zach Henderson, to go in there and signal the fair catch, and
It now becomes a 13-yard punt. I think we're going to have another look at that. I still didn't see it. I saw him wave, Rick.
Yeah, he signaled fair catch, and then he got hit by a Nebraska lineman covering downfield. I believe that was Hover.
Yeah, Hover was signaling. I saw that. Tough yards for Elvis Peacock to midfield. Lee Kuntz made the stop, number 38. Again, Nebraska has to play to get that football. They're trailing 24-7. Not since 1971, when they won 35-31, has Nebraska been able to beat the Sooners. And you know, they've had a great record during that period of time. Osborne himself has had a fine record.
45 wins in 5 years for Tom Osborne.
Here's Watt. Close to a first down at the 45-yard line. George Andrews, number 96, making the stop on him. Thomas Lott has been absolutely sensational today. I have to tell you right off that he gets my vote as the offensive player of the game. 11:36 to go. A little bit early to pick it. Not bad. Not bad. 6.5 yard average. First down on the 45. Pitch back goes to Kenny Brown. He's got a hole. Slices through and then is cut down. I'm sorry, it's meant to David Overstreet. Number 22. David Overstreet is a young man that I think you're going to hear just a tremendous amount about. I think he's probably one of the most sought-after players in all of high school ball. He's just a freshman from Big Sandy, Texas. Everybody knew about him. Second down and 5. 10 minutes, 45 seconds to go in the ball game. The Sooners leading 24-7. 71,148 are on hand here today. And if you look closely, maybe you can see a friend or a relative. Third down and about 2. Ball on the 38-yard line. The Huskers trying to get back in the ball game, but they watch as the seconds move around that big clock. They've been up against an awesome football machine today. Elvis Peacock powering his way to the 30-yard line. I'll tell you, I'm not so sure that Oklahoma isn't the number one team in the country. You know, it's kind of hard to tell. Texas, of course, beat them 13-6 back in early October. Texas has its hands full tomorrow against Texas A&M, and of course, you never can tell what would happen. I mean, let's say that Michigan defeated Alabama in the Orange Bowl, but Notre Dame knocked off Texas if they beat Texas A&M. A lot of implications here. 22 first downs for Oklahoma. And once again, Elvis Peacock gets the ball inside the 25-yard line at the 23. Tom Beering bringing him down. Clock moving, 9:39.
Bill, first it's Kenny King as Bill Lott, and then it's back to Elvis Peacock. Golly, that Nebraska defense has really got it tough today.
Well, when you consider the fact that Oklahoma has only thrown, 5 passes today, completed 2, and yet they've gone, close to 400 yards rushing. Kenny King in motion. Through the middle goes Peacock. Close to a first down. Elvis Peacock. Lee Kuntz, number 38, brought him down.
Stop by Kuntz at the 19-yard line, first and 10, Oklahoma.
It is a first down.
There it is again, the same counter play to Peacock, and all he does is just roar up through there with that quick start, had excellent blocking on that side of the line.
389 yards on the ground. Look at this. Overstreet. Touchdown. David Overstreet from the 19-yard line sprinted into the secondary, took off, and goes in to score. And he is now 37.
Gorgeous Peacock next year. Boy, that Overstreet is something. Look at him here on the belly. They rode the fullback in. There's the lead block by Peacock. Great block. Then he cuts it back. Overstreet just breaks the tackle. He wants 6 points. He's not going to be denied.
And that makes it 30-7. 65 yards in seven plays. It only took a little over 3 minutes to do it. And now it's beginning to look as if the oranges in the end zone have a little bit more significance. Looks like the Sooners will be playing in Miami day after New Year's. It's good. 31-7. 8 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the ball game, and the awesome Sooners of Oklahoma are leading Nebraska. Let's take another look at that fine run by David Overstreet from above. I like the way Baldeswiler, number 67, came back and made that D block in there, too. Let's give credit to the men in the trenches. We'll be back in just a moment.
It's my first car. Where do I get good auto service without a hassle?
Don't you know there's good news round the corner? Goodyear, wherever you are. Goodyear, good and close to home.
Presenting the Goodyear promise for hassle-free auto service. We do professional work. We only do the work you authorize. We return worn-out parts for your inspection. No hassle, no problems, no fooling.
Goodyear tires and Goodyear service for more Goodyears in your car.
This is the Poland Micro 25, a powerful lightweight chainsaw that costs less than you'd guess.
$172.
$139.95.
$153. It has automatic chain oiling, a super quiet muffler, and features you'll find only on more expensive saws. Poland's price, $79.95.
$79.95?
The Poland Micro 25, Poland quality, at a price that's less than you'd guess.
Well, that's pretty much the story of the entire game. It's the fact that Oklahoma has been able to take that ball and pick off 7 or 8, 9 yards at a clip. In the second half alone, they've rushed for 163 yards to only 22 for Nebraska. And Nebraska is a good rushing team. All right, here's Uwe von Schaman. Craig and Brown are back. It's Brown at the six. Ooh. Very fast coverage by Oklahoma puts him down to the 12. So it's first and 10 on the 12-yard line. Randy Garcia goes in, number 18 at quarterback for the Cornhuskers of Nebraska. You know, Rick, the nice thing about games like this, and I said it a week ago in Ann Arbor, there really wasn't a loser there. Michigan goes to the Rose Bowl, Ohio State to the Sugar Bowl. Today, it looks like it'll be Oklahoma in the Orange Bowl, but Nebraska has a bowl trip ahead, too.
That's right, and I'll tell you one thing. Nebraska is getting beat here 31-7, but they're an extremely well-coached football team, and they've just met a team that is just playing just super today in Oklahoma, offensively and defensively. When they said that Oklahoma had one of the fastest teams in the history of football here, they might be right.
Well, the key there is not only fast offensively, but defensively. Second down, about 9. Here's the pitch to Curtis Craig. He swings wide, has two blockers, but he's on the short side. Ooh, did you see that block? Oh, my. Number 70, Brent Morris, wiped out Terry Peters. Just wiped him out. Watch this. Watch number 70 come back.
It's a reverse. Watch number 70 in your film now come back right there. Oh, what a KO.
Reggie Mathis, number 58, brought him down. Curtis Craig leads all the Nebraska runners today. 6 carries, 73 yards. First down. All right, back to passes. Garcia throws to the sideline. He's got a man. It's intercepted by Henderson. His second interception of the day. And this free safety of the Sooners carries it down to the 34-yard line. I have never seen anybody with a nose for the football like he has.
say, you coach and coach, and you might look at a guy and he has great speed or he has this, but when you take a guy like Zach Henderson, when that ball is put in the air, he is around there. That is his seventh interception of the year. He is a true All-American. Here it is now. Garcia's attempting to throw to Tim Smith. He's streaking down the field. Zach Henderson is there. Actually, he was trying to throw to Ken Brown. I'm sorry. Oh, geez. There it is. Oh, he almost dropped the ball.
And a marker down on the last play is going to cost the Huskers for a personal foul, 15 more down to the 19-yard line. Well, Tom Osborne is a little bit on the grim side right now, but I'll tell you something, 8-3 on the season isn't too bad. And Billy Sims, with a marker down, goes to the 15. Hey, Thomas Lott. Yes, you see what they're thinking. They're thinking number one, too. Well, the ABC Evening News with Harry Reasoner and a special feature tonight, Barbara Walters' interview with Menachem Begin and Anwar Sadat, the historic meeting between the Sadat and Begin this past week, and the interview that Barbara did with both of those distinguished gentlemen. Very historic week in the Mideast. Certainly, as far as worldwide news is concerned. Dean Blevins, number two, has gone into quarterback for Oklahoma. Back to pass, and he's got his man. Touchdown. Victor Hicks, the tight end, the big fella. Gets his wish. He gets a TD. How'd you like to have a tight end that weighs 237 pounds and stands 6'3 and a half?
He's kind of happy, I'll tell you that. Boy, what a way for Dean Blevins to come into that ball game. His first play out of the box, and he makes that bootleg fake and throws a touchdown pass to Victor Hicks.
I used to play a little peas porridge hot there with Billy Sims. Well, you know those tight ends, they block, they've got to be tough all year long. They don't get a whole lot of glamour and excitement, and then all of a sudden comes a play like this, and sure, they're excited. Achamanis there putting the tee down. They're flashing Beat Arkansas on the scoreboard here. Arkansas, of course, with a come-from-behind victory over Texas Tech yesterday here on ABC, will be the opponent of Oklahoma in the Orange Bowl. Von Schaumann puts it up. His record is still good. Good, perfect. Let's say on extra points. Dean Blevins, who threw that touchdown pass. Steve Rose there next to him. He's the split end. Not the one who caught the basketball. Let's look at it again.
There it is. They have a motion. There he does a little bootleg. He finds Victor Hicks in the end zone. Touchdown. That's his fifth catch this year, and three of them for touchdowns.
So we have 7 minutes and 28 seconds to go. And the Sooners now up on top, 38-7.
Could Gillette make a razor that does the impossible? Yes. Could it shave closer with even more comfort? Yes. Gillette introduces Atra, the first razor with a pivoting head that safely follows every contour of your face. This Atra face-hugging action keeps the twin blades at the perfect angle. You've never shaved this close with this much comfort.
Impossible.
The new Gillette Atra razor. Yes, it's the impossible shave.
We dads buy these for our kids. But who cares? It's Lionel's Fantastic Power Passers. Look, the cars change lanes with new push-button passing. Hit the button, car steers right. Hit it again, car steers left. And the new high-speed T means that they will never fly off the track, even at top speed.
Okay, your turn. Kid owns the track. You gotta humor him a little, yeah?
Lionel's Power Passers. Exciting new high-speed curves and lane-changing action.
It took tremendous support to send 265 United States student-athletes to the 1977 World University Games last summer. The NCAA wishes to express its thanks to the United States Collegiate Sports Council for sponsoring the U.S. contingent and to the United States Olympic Committee for financing the team.
The tight end who caught the touchdown pass from Lubbock, Texas. And they're playing Auld Lang Syne. The Oklahoma band is today in the final home appearance of the Sooners. Oklahoma has scored on three of the four turnovers today, and that has been pretty much the story of this ball game. As Kenny Brown dances his way back to the 30, knocked out of bounds. Double teamed at the 33 or 34 yard line. Hard hit by Darrell Ray and Terry Peters. So the ball will come out to about the 37 or 38 yard line. 7:21 to go in the ball game. The Sooners now off to a very big and commanding lead. First down. The ball is on the 37 and a half yard line. Oklahoma with 408 on the ground. Nebraska with 189 yards. And back to pass. Sorley incomplete. I'm sorry, it's Ed Burns, not Sorley. Number 17, not number 12. Ed Burns, the third quarterback of Nebraska here today. Burns is a senior from Omaha. So it makes it second down and 10. Incidentally, there's going to be a special feature on the evening news tonight with Harry Reasoner on the great kickers, Russell Erksleben and Tony Franklin. I know you'll enjoy it. Here's Burns. Firing, complete to Spade. Was it Spade? Number 89 in the lineup right now. Junior Miller. Spade is number 86. There on the sidelines behind Tom Osborne. Both teams substituting rather liberally here now with 7 minutes to go. Out wide to the right goes Curtis Craig. Don't forget tonight, USC and UCLA. UCLA wins it, they play Michigan in the Rose Bowl. SC wins it, Washington goes to the bowl. This one is overthrown. Rocky Loken on the receiving end of the Ed Burns pass. Now that's what we said a moment ago. 408 yards rushing. And I want to tell you something. The Nebraska defense is good. I mean, it's not a shabby defense.
I guarantee you they're a good defense, but this Oklahoma offense, just too many weapons.
And there's Jimmy Worth going through the line, number 25. I want to make one correction. On the evening news tonight, the feature on Erksleben and Franklin will be on. The Sadat Begin interview will not be. I thought perhaps there had been an extension of that interview. I happen to see the one that Barbara did with the Sadat and Begin, a very interesting interview. But apparently that was in its entirety. Third down and 7. And it's short of a first down as Dufresne. It's on the receiving end, number 88, Mark Dufresne.
Here it is, that same delay pattern. They like this away from the action. The tight end delays in the vacuum there created by the linebackers going with the flow of the play.
Got an extra defensive back there with an official. Sorley finished the game with 7 out of 9 today for 91 yards. After missing 2, he completed 7 in a row. And this one is complete and a first down at the 38-yard line by Junior Miller, number 89. 5 minutes, 34 seconds to go. The Sooners out in front, 38-7. In case you join us a little bit late today as we watch the replay of Junior Miller, big fella catching this one. Went out to a 14-0 lead. Nebraska made it 14-7. Then it was 21-7, 24-7, 31-7, and now 38-7. And there's the Nebraska fight song. Far side. Ed Burns being chased. Shrugs it off and is hit before he can deliver the ball. George Cumbie Barry Dittman, number 38. 5:18 clock running. Yes, ouch, I guess so. Been a very clean game. Just one major penalty. There's that Arkansas, beat Arkansas sign onto the orange ball. Incidentally, we have two former Heisman Trophy winners here in the press box today. Billy Vessels, who won it 25 years ago for Oklahoma, and Steve Owens, who won it in 69. Rather unusual. We have two on the side of one game. And there's the third interception. And dropped by Basil Banks, number 17. Tim Smith was the intended receiver, but he held it long enough. Was an interception and a fumble, which was recovered by the Sooners. Sherwood Taylor getting the recovery of the fumble, and Basil Banks getting the interception. Here's Timmy Smith, the intended receiver.
All he does is just overshooting right there. The only guy that has a chance is the defensive player, Basil Banks, and he gets his second interception of the year.
The fifth turnover today by Nebraska. Well, that was the old nemesis and bugaboo of the Sooners, who started the season with I don't know how many fumbles early in the first three games, but they developed some concentration, which they said led to lesser fumbles and lesser interceptions.
Bill, can you think what their offense would be like had they not had 29 fumbles up until this ball game? My goodness gracious.
And over 600 yards in penalties.
Oh.
Incidentally, on College Football 77 on Sunday at 12:30 Eastern and Pacific Time and 11:30 Central Time, we're going to have some action from these great games this weekend. Texas A&M, Texas, UCLA, USC, Alabama, Auburn. This game, Arizona, Arizona State, and Grambling and Southern. Here's Buddy Nixon, return leader in the Big Eight, getting a chance on offense out of that wishbone to the 21-yard line. That's this Sunday over most of these ABC stations. As Barry Switzer glances up through the sun at the clock, he sees 3 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Well, that was coming into today's game. This is his fifth year, and this will be his fifth straight win. And I suppose if he add those 38 points to the 110, it makes it even look more impressive. Third down and three. That's all that's remaining of this one. Billy Sims, the carrier. Well, it's always hard to tell what team could be number one in the nation, Rick. I don't know. We've seen all the top teams so far this year. But I really have not seen a team as well-balanced offensively and defensively and with such great speed overall as Oklahoma.
I would agree with you 100% there, Bill. I don't know who's better, but I'll tell you, if they are, they've got to be a great football team because Oklahoma is great.
That's Timmy Wirth. As Barry Switzer must be very happy inwardly, although you can never tell from his face exactly what he's thinking. But Nebraska will get the ball, and we have 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go.
There's 85 feet between you and the ground, and there's enough juice at your fingertips to light up the county. But now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best-tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
When it's time to relax, Miller stands clear.
Beer after beer, if you got the time, we got the beer. Miller beer. See what's new today.
Chevrolet introduces a new kind of space vehicle, the new size Malibu wagon. It has a new and very convenient two-way hatch gate and an amazing amount of interior space. You can load the new size Malibu with the tailgate down or with it up. And when you finish loading, there's still ample room for family and friends. Chevy's new size Malibu wagon. It's the kind of friend a modern family can use.
Great NCAA college football action continues tonight with an outstanding regional lineup as UCLA must beat USC to earn a trip to the Rose Bowl. Then, a big doubleheader begins tomorrow afternoon as number 8 Penn State battles number 9 Pittsburgh in a showdown for East Coast supremacy. Then the color and pageantry of the Army-Navy game highlights regional coverage in the second game of an outstanding NCAA college football doubleheader tomorrow on ABC.
Rick, if you total that up, it's 380 yards, and their total offense is 417 on the ground.
Wow.
Pretty well split. David Overstreet had the 19 yards in there. All right, back to pass. Burns throws out of bounds. 2:44 to go. Andre Franklin. Amos Lawrence, that freshman from North Carolina, is really something to watch. He set an NCAA record of 286 yards in a game a couple of weeks ago. So the Nebraska defense will be tested. Inside handoff. Well, a lot of juking, but not much forward progress.
Well, he ran east and west a long way, but not north and south.
I am hip has had his problems here today. That Oklahoma defense was really keyed up for him. Barry Switzer said yesterday, we stop hip, we'll stop. Well, the final tally so far anyway is 21 yards for hip in 12 carries. 2 minutes, 9 seconds to go. Third down, six. On the draw, hip. Buckle at the 43. Very close to a first down.
You know, all great athletes have games like this, and he's playing, Hip is playing against a great defense, but he's a young man who's going to be back to play more times than this against Oklahoma, and I'm sure he'll have his day in court.
Well, we're going to have to vote on the offensive and defensive players of the game, Rick. I want you to be thinking about that.
I'll be thinking, Bill.
Want to pass me a note? Fourth down. Lot of foot. Ed Burns, the quarterback. Fourth down and a foot to go. And the handoff goes to I.M. Hip, who has the first down. One minute, 51 seconds to go. The ball at the 45-yard line. Here's Ed Burns. Fires to the sideline, incomplete. Tim Smith, number 84, the split end. And it stops the clock. 1 minute and 42 seconds to go. Again, a reminder to you that it's USC and UCLA over most of the our ABC stations tonight. Some stations will be getting the Arizona State-Arizona game, others the Southwest Louisiana-McNeese game. Then tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern time, national telecast of the Pitt-Penn State game. We have the Army-Navy game. Some sections of the country will see Southern and Grambling. Everybody will see the coverage live of the Texas A&M Texas game. We'll be going there periodically as the action warrants it for the live coverage of that game. So it's a big day tomorrow here on ABC, as well as a big night tonight. Saw a marker down there. Interference against the Sooners. That is the fifth penalty. 25 yards. It's a first down, of course, automatically. Ed Burns back to throw. He's got his man on the sideline, and he can't hold it. Number 26 on the sideline of Nebraska was Jeff Lee. I don't know that he could have caught it and stayed in bounds, but the pass was very well thrown. There's a marker down also on this play. 1 minute, 33 seconds to go.
Bill, even though the score is 38-7, I'm sure that Oklahoma right now is thinking about that statistic of 68 points that they've scored in the fourth quarter against Nebraska. Nebraska has not scored in the last four games in the fourth quarter against Oklahoma.
Well, Thomas Lott is our
keep it intact
offensive player of the game. And in his name, to the General Scholarship Fund at the University of Oklahoma, Chevrolet will send $1,000. Congratulations, Thomas. Second time you have had that award in your name given this year. First down. Should be second down. Oh, that's right. There was a offsetting penalties on the first. Back there somewhere is our Chevrolet defensive player of the game. He wears number 62, Reggie Kinlaw. And in his name will go a $1,000 scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund. Boy, he has been awesome today. Hard to pick, though. Incomplete. Even though the award goes to Kinlaw, I really do want to mention Reggie Mathis, Zach Henderson, George Cumbie, Daryl Hunt, who have all been just great. And I think we'd be remiss if we didn't talk about Nebraska defensively today with Jim Pillins and Lee Coons. George Andrews played strongly, as did Weinmaster. Back to pass is Ed Burns being tugged at. Can't find any place to go. Down he goes to the 41-yard line. Doug Simchick was in on the stop. Loss of 13 yards on the play. Well, it's fourth down. Clock running out now. And it has OU number one up on the scoreboard. You'll see lots of fans going out of here today at Owen Field. Chanting, we're number one. Well, this is one broadcaster who will not question that.
I'll tell you, it's tough to dispute it after seeing them. Wow. They are a great football team, and it's been a great football game, but Oklahoma just had too many guns for Nebraska today.
Hey, boss! The Texaco guy's at it again!
What?
Now what? It's an antifreeze wiper refill special.
1 gallon of Texaco antifreeze coolant plus 2 wiper blade refills.
Only incredible. A pair of refills alone can cost up to $5.
Yeah.
How can he do it?
Because I'm a good guy.
Texaco antifreeze and wiper refills at a special low price. At your participating Texaco good guys.
I have a confession to make. Last year, the abbot asked me to do an impossible job. Copy 500 sets of this manuscript. I did it, but I used the Xerox 9200. Now, to save paper, he wants it copied on both sides, and he wants it fast. This is going to take another miracle.
Where do you want it, Brother Dominic?
Right here!
The Xerox 9400 duplicator with automatic two-sided copying. Will miracles never cease?
Only 14 seconds are showing on the clock now. The ball on the 41-yard line, and Tim Smith is in to do the punting. You may say, well, why punt here? Well, there's always a chance for a fumble and make it a little more respectable, but the game, of course, is out of reach. As this one goes down, bounces on the 10-yard line, and the clock is ticking away with every bounce of the ball. Stops with 3 seconds to go, and the Sooners will take over the football. And the fans start to swarm onto the field here, and they start throwing oranges all over the place. Oh, this is going to be a mess.
I think the best thing to do in a situation like this is just call the ball game over. There's 3 seconds left. It's 38-7. Why run another play?
Best thing to do here is to get a squeezer.
I like it.
I don't know what's going on over there on the far side of the field. Coach Switzer is right there in the middle. Well, it'll be a big celebration here in Norman tonight. On to the Orange Bowl of Miami. 3 seconds to go. They'll just kill the clock. And that is it. And so the Sooners carry off a hard-earned 38-7 victory over a dogged, determined Nebraska team that simply couldn't handle the power and the speed today of the Oklahoma Sooners. And Barry is looking anxiously on this side of the field to try to find Tom Osborne to wish him well in the Liberty Bowl. And I'm sure Tom wishes Barry Switzer well in the Orange Bowl.
What's new today?
Stare hard at this new Chevrolet Caprice Coupe, and you'll see something most unusual. Full-size grown-up human beings riding comfortably in the back seat with ample leg room. And in the trunk, almost 20 cubic feet of luggage space. The new Chevrolet Caprice Coupe with more trunk room, more headroom, and more rear seat leg room. It's as easy on the knees as it is on the eyes.
You'll never regret the purchase of a good stock.
You don't say.
Yeah, my broker says it's a real good buy. What does your broker say?
Well, my broker's E.F. Hutton. And Hutton says...
When E.F. Hutton talks, people listen.
How do you spell relief?
When I get acid indigestion, I spell relief. R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
For heartburn? R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. In this test with Rolaid's active ingredient, laboratory acid changes color to prove Rolaid's consumes 47 times its weight in excess stomach acid. How do you spell relief?
For gas? I spell it R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief.
Goodyear announces Tiempo. Now you can eliminate winter tire changeover. Tiempo, a steel-belted radial for all weather conditions.
You can drive a Goodyear Tiempo through an Arizona summer, through a winter in Wisconsin and a springtime rain in Georgia, an autumn in Vermont. You can drive a Goodyear Tiempo whenever, wherever you want.
Tiempo with a protective sidewall scuff bar from $39. Keep it on season after season.
Well, they're whooping it up in Norman, and well, they should. Their team has performed proudly today, beating the Cornhuskers of Nebraska 38-7. And as the fans try to soak up the last bit of sunshine and glory, the Oklahoma band is on the field, the pride of Oklahoma, and they'll be serenading the fans here in their post-game show. Well, the Sooners waited until 2 seconds of the second quarter to score. But from then on, it was all Oklahoma. Nebraska tried gamely, made it 14-7, but that was the last that Nebraska could score. And from there on, it was 24 unanswered points, and it wound up Oklahoma 38, Nebraska 7. Let's get a final word with Rick Forzano. What'd you think, Rick?
Oh, I'll tell you,
it's better than watching it at home, isn't it?
Oh, I'll tell you, even though it's 38-7, it was a fine ball game. It was just great to be here, Bill, and to see this Oklahoma football team with its speed. When they talk about speed, boy, I'll tell you, no one, Oklahoma takes a backseat to no one in that. Overall team speed, unbelievable.
The executive producer of NCAA football is Drew Norley. Today's coverage of the Nebraska-Oklahoma game was produced by Joe Assetti, directed by Larry Camp, technical director Joe Nisi, associate director Carol Letty. This is Bill Fleming, along with Rick Forzano, saying so long from Owen Field in Norman, Oklahoma. Be with us again tonight when the Trojans of USC meet the Bruins of UCLA in a must-win game for the Bruins to assure them a bid for the Rose Bowl. Also tonight, Arizona and Arizona State, McNeese State in southwest Louisiana. Regional coverage tonight beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern time. Then tomorrow at 12:30 Eastern, it's doubleheader action, Penn State battling Pittsburgh to determine who is the best on the East Coast, followed by the classic Army-Navy game. Portions of the South will see the Grambling Southern game. NCAA college football, Nebraska against Oklahoma, has been brought to you by Goodyear, the makers of Tiempo steel-belted radials, a new kind of tire for every kind of weather. Keep it on season after season. By the investment firm of E.F. Hutton and Company. When E.F. Hutton talks, people listen. And by Rolaids for acid indigestion. Rolaids. Rolaids spells relief. Consumes 47 times its weight in excess stomach acid. Travel arrangements paid through and a promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United built the largest airline in the free world around you. Once again, the final score. Oklahoma 38, Nebraska 7. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in...